96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Good morning. Massive turnout for holiday freebies. As one cabinet minister says, politicians can't do everything. F&M Chairman Dwight Sands claims the misery index is rising. And work on the National Development Plan to resume in earnest in 2024. It's all straight ahead this morning. I'm Dwight Strachan, and this is Morning Blend.
Wake up. It's a new day. Wake up, it's a new day. It's the start of the start of a new way. You know that it's the start of the end of the old way. Wake up, it's a new day. Wake up, it's a new day.
Good morning again, Bahamas. It is Friday, December 22nd, 2023. This is Morning Blend on Guardian Radio 96.9. Again, I'm Dwight Strachan. In a moment, Stephen Hanna will be joining us. Also this morning, we're going to get a preview of the Phil Stubbs concert that is scheduled for in just a few weeks, January, at the Nassau Cruise Port. And Dr. Dee Archer, who has had a long-running show on Guardian Radio, the doctor is in. She's scheduled to make quick appearance, wants to say something to her loyal listeners this morning and something special for them. And then later, they're supposed to be with us early in the week, but they're going to be with us today. And this might be a fitting way to do our final show before Christmas. Bristol Wines and Spirits will be with us in business this morning. That's all straight ahead on this Friday. But first, it's time for the overnight, the latest breaking news from while you're sleeping, and the top national and international headlines this morning. Overnight streets leading to Thomas A. Robinson National Stadium in New Providence clogged for hours yesterday as the Fox Foundation gave handouts intended to make the holidays a bit merrier for Bahamians, particularly those in need. Co-founder of the foundation and daughter of the local entrepreneur Adrian Fox, Adriana Fox, said $350,000 worth of Solomon's vouchers were being distributed in $50 increments. The giveaway before Christmas brought Bahamians out in the thousands and was followed by a celebration complete with cotton candy, face painting, and a bouncing castle in the Kemp Road area where Adrian Fox grew up. Adriana Fox said the foundation was giving away a variety of items, including bicycles, scooters, iPads, Apple Watches, and Sports Center vouchers to children and hams and turkeys to the adults at the Kemp Road event. Fox said that although the turnout was massive, she expected every child to receive a gift. Freetown MP Wayne Monroe, who's also Minister of National Security, said the initiative is an example of what's needed in communities across the country. He said, quote, as politicians, we cannot do everything. The government cannot do everything. So when you have somebody who is from an area giving back to an area, being concerned about the area, that is what we need. This is what we mean when we say we have to be our brothers and sisters keepers. Adrian Fox said the reaction from the community more than justifies the decision to host the giveaway. Meanwhile, F&M Chairman Dr. Dwayne Sands says though the Bahamas is celebrating a record year for tourism, the economy is in a poor state and Bahamians are suffering, as he called on the government to stop trying to fix the economy through taxation. He says, quote, either way, they are out of touch and they are disingenuous and dishonest, and they're trying to sell dreams about what's going on. Sand says that the Red Cross's recent announcement of unrestricted donations falling off by nearly 60%, while more people are seeking assistance, is an indicator of the true state of the economy. Chairman of the National Development Plan Steering Committee, Felix Stubbs, says work on the plan will resume in earnest early in the new year. Stubbs says the delay has been in finding a team who can man the secretariat. He says he hopes to have that sorted out shortly. And a Supreme Court judge adjusting the bail terms for an American housewife accused of plotting to kill her husband, paving the way for her return to the United States. Lindsay Shiver was accused of conspiring with her Bahamian boyfriend Terrence Bethel and Ferran Newbold to bump off her husband. Robert said that the remaining in the Bahamas until her March 4th trial date could cause severe financial hardship. According to her lawyer, Owen Wells, Shiver has spent $30,000 on lodging and $20,000 on car rentals since she was freed on $100,000 cash bail on August 9th. Wells says that Shiver had exhausted her resources and was relying on her parents for financial support since the mother of three does not work. In an affidavit in support of the bail modification, Shiver says she intends to return for her trial because absconding would destroy any prospect of resuming parental relations. Prosecutors did not object to Shiver's return to the U.S. pending her murder conspiracy trial, which is scheduled for March 4th. However, they asked that she not come within 100 feet of her husband. Overseas, more than 20,000 Palestinians have died in Gaza during Israel's war against Hamas. That's according to health officials, who say today the latest indication of the staggering cost of the conflict is showing that Israel expands its ground offensive and orders tens of thousands more people to leave their homes. The deaths amounting to nearly 1% of the territory's pre-war population. Just one measure of the devastating effects of the conflict over the 11 weeks that's displaced nearly 85% of Gaza's people and leveled wide swaths of the tiny coastal enclave. More than 500,000 people in Gaza, a quarter of the population, are starving, according to a report Thursday from the United Nations and other agencies, describing the crisis caused by Israel's bombardment and siege on the territory in response to Hamas's October 7th attack. Despite the emergency, a UN Security Council vote on aid deliveries and terms for a ceasefire was delayed again late Thursday after days of high-level negotiations. The United States, which has veto power, has pushed back against calls for an immediate ceasefire and giving the UN sole responsibility for inspecting aid deliveries. Israel, citing security grounds, insists it needs to be able to screen goods entering Gaza. And a student opened fire at a university in Prague Thursday, killing at least 14 people and injuring more than 20 in the Czech Republic's worst mass shooting. The bloodshed took place in the philosophy department building of Charles University, where the shooter was a student. The gunman also died. His name has not been released. The chief of police says that in the evening, 14 people had died and 25 were injured, after early reports said 15 had died and 24 were hurt. The change in numbers has not been explained. Authorities warned that the death toll could rise, though. Police giving no details about the victims or a possible motive for the shooting. And the building located near the Vltava River. The Czech Interior Minister said investigators do not suspect a link to any extremist ideology or groups. In sports, after 4 days of intense competition, seasoned players Baker Newman and Simone Pratt coming out on top at the Giorgio Baldacci Open National Tennis Championships, winning in three sets each at the Bahamas Lawn Tennis Association's National Tennis Center. Newman got the best of Rodney Carey Jr. for the men's title, and Pratt winning again on the women's side against last year's runner-up Sydney Clark to lift that title. You can read about the scores in it. All the details in today's Guardian Sports section. And there's no doubt that the pool at the Betty Kelly Kenning National Swim Complex needs repairs, particularly heading into a Carifta hosting year. Driving past the pool, workers can be seen doing all they can on the pool, and some people have doubts, though, that the pool will be ready by the start of the 30th Carifta Swimming Championship, set for March 28th through April 7th. But Minister of Youth, Sports and Culture Mario Boleg, hoping to quell those thoughts by saying that he is confident that the pool will be ready in time for the championships, making the statement at a press conference held at the ministry's headquarters this week as the championships, the official announcement. The official launch took place this week. Read more about why he's confident in today's Guardian Sports section. And from the NFL, the Los Angeles Rams holding off the New Orleans Saints for a 30-22 win last night as they surge forward in the NFC playoff race. From the NBA, Minnesota Timberwolves handing LeBron-less Lakers, he wasn't playing, their fourth straight loss, 118-111. And the pathetic Detroit Pistons dropping their 25th straight to move within a loss of tying the NBA's single season record. The 2010-11 Cleveland Cavaliers and the 2013-14 Philadelphia 76ers share the record of 26. The 76ers hold the overall mark at 28, a skid that started in the 2014-15 season and carried over into the 2015-16 season. The Pistons falling 2-26 with the crowd chanting, sell the team, at the end in a loud statement to owner Tom Gores. Detroit will be back in action Saturday night in Brooklyn. 2-26 for the season. At sports, and that's the overnight. Time for your first look at weather. Your first look at weather for today. We've got high pressure still influencing weather over the country. It's going to continue to generate moderate to fresh breezes. Small craft operators, though, should not venture far from port, and beachgoers advised to remain onshore due to high seas, rough surf, and dangerous rip currents, especially along northern and eastern shorelines. For all areas today, we're looking at variably cloudy, mild, and breezy conditions with spotty showers through tonight. Small craft operators again advised not to venture far from port due to swells. Winds northeast to east at 15 to 20 knots with higher gusts. Seas 4 to 6 feet near shore, building up to 9 feet offshore, and along Atlantic exposures in northeast to easterly swells. Right now, Nassau, it's about 70 degrees under partly cloudy skies. We're looking at highs getting up to around 77 Fahrenheit, 25 Celsius. Overnight lows tonight getting down to about 68 Fahrenheit, 20 Celsius. That's your first look at weather this morning. We'll have your extended outlook coming up after traffic in just a bit.
Wake up, it's a new day. Wake up, it's a new day.
You're listening to Morning Blend. When we come back, we're discussing the day's top stories right here on your home for fresh news and smart talk all day. Guardian Radio 96.9.
Wake up.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
Enjoy great savings this holiday on your favorite water, AquaPure. Now until December 31st, take advantage of AquaPure's Christmas coupon special. Purchase a book of 10 5-gallon coupons for just $37.50 plus VAT, regularly $42.50 plus VAT. And best of all, these coupons never expire. Be sure to take advantage of this great offer, AquaPure's Christmas coupon special, going on now. Call 394-7873 or order online at aquapure242.com.
Champ, baby girl, Cable Guy is here.
Since the very beginning, you have been with us.
This is Paul Wayne, and this is called the Internet.
Right, so for over two decades, we've been with you every step of the way.
Mila Weibo is total class. Look at her go. She's in front.
I follow me. I'm president.
So, yeah, times may have changed, and so have your needs as our valued customers. But some connections stand the test of time. Red, we're with you.
At Wendy's, we are different. We don't just use beef. It's fresh, never frozen. Our burgers are square because we never cut corners. Served hot off the grill with fresh lettuce, tomatoes, onions, and American cheese. We believe in fast food done right. Always serving fresh, never frozen beef. Order a hot, juicy Dave single, double, or triple. Made with fresh, never frozen beef. Now only at Wendy's. Different inside and out.
To us, the heights of the season, Scotiabank wanted to give the people a lift for mom, dad, and kids. Apply for a Scotiaplan loan and unwrap the perfect Christmas gift. Fix your home, buy new appliances, or go on vacation. Scotiabank is giving holiday cheer with an all-expense-paid weekend trip for two to Miami for 3 days and two nights. When you apply for a Scotiaplan loan from now until December 31st, enjoy low interest rates and no payments for up to 2 months. Unwrap the perfect Christmas with Scotiabank.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment terms that suits your financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Doctors Hospital has reimagined primary care. We have invested to improve our health system, ensuring that accessible, affordable, world-class clinical care is closer to you. We understand that your relationship with a primary care provider shapes the foundation of your overall health. Our new modern primary care facilities are where critical diagnoses and true personalized treatment begins. With locations across New Providence, Grand Bahama, and Exuma, we invite you to experience the Doctor's Hospital difference. Book your next appointment at clinics.doctorshosp.com.
Cashmas time, here we go. Mercy's doing it big this year. Cashmas time with extra chair. 12 days of merry winnings from your friends at Island Bay. Friends we trust, hey, we know. Cashmas time, here we go. Prizes and lots of dough. This Christmas, come catch a lick with 20 on your account. Quick, quick, quick. And you can win some awesome stuff
at Mercy's Island Bay.
To us, the heights of the season, Scotiabank wanted to give the people a lift for mom, dad, and kids. Apply for a Scotiaplan loan and unwrap the perfect Christmas gift. Fix your home, buy new appliances, or go on vacation. Scotiabank is giving holiday cheer with an all-expense-paid weekend trip for two to Miami for 3 days and two nights. When you apply for a Scotiaplan loan from now until December 31st, enjoy low interest rates and no payments for up to 2 months. Unwrap the perfect Christmas with Scotiabank.
Wake up, it's a new day. Wake up, it's a new day. It's the start of a new way. You know that it's the start of the end of the old way. Wake up.
Welcome back to Morning Blend here on Guardian Radio 96.9. We're streaming live on GuardianTalkRadio.com and on the Guardian Radio app for smart devices. We're also on your televisions on Cable Bahamas Channel 969 and BTC Flow Channel 612. You can tweet us at MorningBlend969 or Facebook.com/MorningBlend969. Text us on the Guardian Radio text line powered by BTC 422-4796. Standard text rate supply. Once again, I'm Dwight Strachan. Join me now, Stephen Hanna. Stephen Hanna, Merry Christmas, sir.
It's not Christmas yet.
You can say it. It's Christmas time. You can say it. You don't have to say it on the one day. Do you only say it on Christmas Day?
I mean, you cheapen it when you say it every day.
What?
You don't tell random people happy birthday.
It's not the same.
A month out.
It's a season. It's not the same. See, I told you last week not to be the Grinch today.
I'm not being the Grinch.
I tell you Merry Christmas and you say, it's not Christmas. Like, what? what's up with you? I'm going to wrap you in one of our Christmas bows.
You can have an extra piece of coal.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so representing the Grinch today, Stephen Hanna, he's here. We'll see if we can get some Christmas cheer into him before the end of the show. But we've got a lot to talk about this morning, a lot happening in the news. Just a reminder to pick up today's NASA Guardian, all the details, the handy booklet, the supplement is in there about the JCNP and the Boxing Day New Year's Day parades, everything you need to know, the order of entry, the themes, information about
how many did
judging.
I get right?
The Boxing Day sounds like it's going to be a little bit. I'm curious about some of the themes for Boxing Day. Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Cratchit.
We're gonna see how this goes. But anyway, that's in today's NASA Guardian, only in the NASA Guardian. So you got to pick up today's NASA Guardian for all of that information today. All right, so we're going to be talking briefly with Dr. Dee Archer from The Doctor Is In. Her final show is Tuesday, but she has something special for listeners coming in a few minutes. And then later in our 8 o'clock hour, we're going to be talking about the Phil Stubbs concert that's coming up next month, which is just days away, right? We'll get details about what's going to be happening there at Nassau Cruise Port. And then in our 9 o'clock business hour, our monthly segment with Bristol Wines and Spirits, we're going to be talking with them and having a great time as we get ready for Christmas this morning. So a lot to get to. Let's begin, though, with what else is in the news. And in the news, we were telling about it yesterday, the very long lines that wrapped around, completely encircled the sports center complex, not just one building, the entire area, for miles, miles and miles of cars for the Fox Foundation giveaway yesterday, then moved into the Kemp Road area, so there was a lot going on yesterday. For more on what was happening, take a listen to this report from our Jared Higgs.
Christmas giveaway today. During the event, the foundation gave away $350,000 worth of Solomon's food vouchers in $50 increments, according to co-founder of the Fox Foundation, Adriana Fox.
Today is the day that we touch the Bohemian people, you know, making them put a smile on their face so at least they could go buy their ham and turkey or just even snacks or essentials for the home.
Later in the day in Kemp Road, the group had another major giveaway. This time, giving away $30,000 worth of gifts, Fox said.
Kids' toys, and also we engaged with the sports center to give some sports center vouchers for the kids. Because it's not always about a toy. Some persons have essentials that they need, such as tennis and gym clothes. I don't know what it is. But we wanted to separate it from just toys and gifts. So we have scooters, we have bicycles, we have Apple Watches, we have tablets. We just have Barbie dolls. We have every age bracket. We have it from 0 to 10, 11 to 17. Just to make, I must say, this is bigger than we literally expected. But I do think every kid is going to get a welcome gift.
Island Luck co-owner Adrian Fox said it brings joy to his heart when he is able to help people.
Well, what it means to me to give back is, you know, when you see the smiles on everybody's faces, you know, bringing joy to your heart. It makes you feel like, hey, you're doing something right.
He thanked Freetown MP Wayne Monroe for his support with the event.
He called me and said, Fox, now, when you have this event, I can send you some money. So he sent me a couple of dollars. Wasn't that much, but he sent me a couple of dollars to help out. You know what I mean? And I like that. You know, he's a man for the people, and I love that.
As politicians, you cannot do everything. The government cannot do everything. So when you have somebody who is from an area, giving back to an area, being concerned about the area, that is what we mean. That's what we mean when we say we have to be our brothers and sisters keeper. So you have somebody who grew up here, who were on the streets themselves, who experienced success, and that for themselves, but make sure that they give back.
All right, Jared Higgs with that report there. All right, let's get your reaction to it. I believe the member of parliament was speaking there because this was happening in his constituency. That's the Kemp Road event. But, I know a lot of you had a lot to say yesterday about what happened at the stadium and concerns about it disrupting traffic so much and whether it should be on the Saturday before Christmas or something like that. That might be, I don't know if that would make too much, well, it would be definitely better for people who are struggling to get to work, but people have to get to work on Saturdays too, but not as many. I don't know. What do you make of that one? Any other ideas? But again, we salute the Fox Foundation. It's wonderful what they're doing, but the reaction is insane.
It's an event. They have, it is what it is intended to be.
A spectacle.
Yes. Mm-hmm. If they wanted it to be smaller and less conspicuous.
Intrusive.
They would do so.
Yeah.
They were able to do so for decades and decades with numbers. For decades and decades, numbers was nearly invisible, except to the people who knew what it was. Mm-hmm. But this is a spectacle for a reason.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
Yeah, well. And it's hard, especially after seeing the numbers yesterday, to say that there are more people angry than the people who are in the line. I don't know. There were places that are normally swamped with customers yesterday morning that were quite empty. And you have to assume that it was because of that.
You mean like roadside vendors?
No, I actually went to some supermarkets, some stores, and nobody was in there. Which is crazy, right? A few days before Christmas. But I'm sure the story changed later in the day.
Yeah, they had, well, it's all with gift cards, so never mind.
But yeah, so let's talk about it. What do we think should be happening here? I mean, yes, they may, it achieves the purpose they want, but it's disruptive to a whole lot of people, and that's not how communities work, right? It doesn't matter what you want. If it's going to mess up the citizenry, somebody has to intervene. If we had a mayor. Anyway, somebody would intervene because it just can't continue like this. It's going to get bigger and bigger, and soon every single street is going to be impacted. All the other arteries that people could think of to get around it were clogged up yesterday as well, and it was much worse than normal traffic that we see even on school mornings. So it is disruptive. People are trying to get to the airport, people trying to get to work, people trying to do all kinds of things. The hospital, God, imagine if you were in an ambulance yesterday. What would you do?
Well, they had a helicopter at the Big Bang, yeah. So maybe they'll let you use that.
Oh, dear Lord.
Wow.
Yeah.
All of my solutions, I wouldn't say controversial, but will upset people. So. Yeah.
Well, let's give out the numbers and take a call, and then we'll get to your upsetting solutions. We'd expect no less from the Grinch this close to Christmas. But 323-6232. 325-4316, 325-4259, and toll free 242-300-5720. Tweet us, Facebook us, text us 4224796.
Just so you know, the people of Whoville were the villain of the story, the Grinch, not the Grinch.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the Grinch would say that. The Grinch would say that.
Yeah.
Cindy Lou Who is a villain. That's her name, right? That was her name.
Hey, man. You can't liberate a village without apparently bombing it into the Stone Age.
I see, now look where you're going. It's Christmas, sir. Yeah. It's Christmas. Good morning. You're on the air.
Jesus was a Palestinian.
Good morning, Stephen.
Hi, good morning. Morning.
Merry Christmas to you guys.
Yeah, same to you. Same to you.
All right.
Okay. If I must, what I suggest is walk to back. Okay, because it relates to the Big Bash and the giveaway that they do, like what took place on yesterday. I think they probably really need to sit back and think about it. Because if they're trying to touch persons who need it the most, you know, to hear about some persons walking up without trams, I mean, they need it. They don't even have a transportation. When you watch the news, you could see persons with the kid walking to try to retrieve whatever it is that they were given. So I feel like if you really want to touch the person who are hurting and need it, they need to probably, I mean, I'm thinking about of a warehouse where they could purchase food and sell it at a retail price, or clothing or school supply or something. Just open up that location where a person could be able to, you know, go there and use that little bit of money that they have and gain something from it, rather than all these, how much millions did they spend yesterday?
But that's what they want to do. They want to do a giveaway. They don't necessarily, and I don't know if you really want them to get into retail, like that type of retail.
I mean, I would mind.
You know? But yeah, it's a Christmas giveaway. So
I know the Christmas person is, you're not still reaching the person who needed the most. What do you think? You're still not reaching. Your aim is to try to put meal on somebody's plate around this time of the year, right? Mm-hmm. But you got everybody in there. the ones who need it the most can even get there.
Yeah, but if you...
they say they don't have means of getting there.
Yeah, but if you make a food store, right,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
you still would have the same problem, but even more so because you still need to purchase it. Now, if you're talking about, like, having a food store set up and it's free of charge, then, like...
I mean purchase it. You're purchasing it at a lesser price.
Yeah, but I'm still buying it. You still have money.
Stretch.
You'd still need money.
You'd
still need money.
The thing is, we have
and
these...
And it's still limit who gets it.
We have these things that you're talking about already. Maybe that's what you're saying, that they should donate more to... the Red Cross, to Hands for Hunger, to the Hunger Feeding Network.
Yeah,
everybody has a pantry.
They have a pantry on Comerica Road that you can
need
walk
it.
Into.
Red Cross is saying they need the donations. They can't do their feeding program. So they don't need to create anything new. Just we're saying is what you think they should do.
Right.
So that would only probably cause more problems.
And then also, and God forbid that I be in defense of the number boys, but...
No, my idea comes from... I don't know if you're familiar with the liquidation, the place on the highway at Boina.
Yeah.
You ever visited that place?
Yes.
Well, when they first... Think about when they first opened. You could have gone there and you could get things at a Miami price.
Yeah, that's because...
Like you're in a swap market.
Yeah, but that's because it's liquidated stuff. That's things that people like either didn't clear or... They lost through some sort of settlement, and so the price is reduced for that reason. But with that said, at the end of the day, I couldn't buy a fridge there if I didn't have money. So it's still not going to address the bottom issue that you're talking about. The easier way to address the main issue that you're talking about would be for them to invest in the people who are already doing it as opposed to starting from scratch. So it's like you have Hands for Hunger, you have Salvation Army, you have Red Cross, you have the Bombers Feeding Network, you have a variety of persons who are out there. What's the name of the guy around the corner from here that has a line in the road every lunchtime?
Great Commission.
Great Commission. Right?
Bishop
Angel. Right? Mm-hmm. Right? So it's like you have these people who are doing that work already. So if that was the specific thing, then you could do that. But I dare say, I think that what they were trying to do is give it to everybody, whether you're rich or poor, is to give back to behemoths.
Yeah.
I hate to be in defense of them, but if they're just trying to spread share across the board, they can't say, well, tell me how much money you make. Oh, no, you make $20,000 a year. You should be able to figure out life for yourself. Oh, you make $50,000. It literally is like whether you're rich or poor.
What you're saying exists, and so we just need to support them,
right.
Those who are doing it. All right, and thank you very much for calling, though. And some people already have their hands in a lot of things, and
we're gonna
end up with one company running the whole country.
Amazon,
soon.
Fingers crossed.
They might buy that one too. So if we keep this up, continue to call in 323-6232-325-4316. 325-4259, toll free, 242-300-5720.
So my question is, did they get, since the Minister of National Security was there, right? Did they get
At the Kemp Road one.
Mm-hmm. Like, I assume that they got what you call it? Because if I wanted to block up the road, I need to get permission from the...
This is a Kemp Road thing.
No, I know, so I know. I'm saying...
Two different events.
I know it's two different events. I'm saying for the one that happened... At the sports center, if I'm going to obstruct traffic, let's say I want to have a parade, I got to go to the police to get a permission.
Well, the police, were aware and were making appeals. They were on the show making appeals. But this year was different from last year. Last year was a real nightmare. They did block up the road.
Right.
This year, the police got them to go on the side. So they were on the grass. They were on the side of all the
roads.
I know
you're answering your question without like saying, I don't know.
I mean,
it's all
things like that can't happen without permission.
I know.
So, but
and then
trying to do what they could to prevent it from really blocking up areas.
Now, this is the question.
It could have been worse.
Does,
which is shocking.
When you're doing a PR thing or a marketing thing, is it a different requirement than when you're just doing a regular thing? Like, let's say if you're just having junk canoe, right, you get permission to perform junk canoe in the street. I imagine that shouldn't come at a cost. It's a cultural thing. Would this come at a cost? Like, oh, y'all want to block up the street, then it's this much. I told you none of my solutions will make anybody happy.
So what do you want to do?
I would like to charge them.
Oh, my God.
Not the people in the cars. The people who decide to... Because this could have been done through satellite operations. There are enough number houses all over this country in every ghetto. Go to... With me in one ghetto that don't have a number house in it.
Name one neighborhood.
Right, because they're even out west now, right?
They're everywhere.
So if they're all over the place, they could have split this up. Right? And they could have had distribution centers in different locations. But it wouldn't look as well as it did. If you want to be big and powerful, then you got to pay big and powerful prices. That is Stephen's solution.
Well, okay. There are going to be issues with that as well, though.
There's always issues, right?
Because some areas will have much larger numbers of people showing up.
Yeah, but they're coming on foot. Because in their neighborhood, it won't be blocking up traffic. Not the way this is blocking up traffic.
You're going to require them to come on foot?
No, you wouldn't have to. If I live around the corner from a number house, why am I driving there?
Please. People are driving across the street.
I'm saying, think about it, Dwight. The majority of people won't come in the car if they know they got to get out the car to go inside anyway.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like this, it's a very straightforward situation.
All right. They might already have to pay, from what I'm being told. So, but they can afford it. If anyone can afford
it won't make a difference, though,
as you see.
I'm saying if we are going to be inconvenienced as the public, then the public needs to be made aware of how we are all being benefiting from it as well.
Okay.
That's it. That was the whole sentence.
How are we all benefiting?
Like this,
because the government got a little bit of money for it? Yeah, okay.
If your next story was talking about somebody complaining about government revenue, about the government is trying to tax us into something. No. So it's like that's revenue is revenue, bro. Every bit of revenue the government gets is technically taxed.
Mm. Well, hey, a Saturday might not prevent you from getting to work, but it would still be a spectacle and people would still be talking about it.
It would be more frustrating if it's Saturday, because Saturday, if Saturday's the only day you have off and then you mistakenly, because now I was able to avoid that because I didn't have to go that way because it's a work day. I don't have to go this. I didn't have to go past there. But now imagine on a Saturday, I drive and I say, oh, I need to go to the store over there. Bam, in the middle of this traffic. Mm-hmm. I didn't know or I didn't remember.
Well, you should be paying attention to your favorite morning show and then you would know about it.
But I was listening to The Guardian.
Mm-hmm. Excuse me? We sometimes... good morning, caller. You are there. Are you there?
Hello.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning, Stephen. Greetings to you all.
And to you.
And you as well.
I remember when I was in a situation and he's not there now, Mr. Warren McCartney. Mm-hmm. Yes, I'll never forget him. I'm a senior, mm-hmm. and they were giving up vouchers, and they were all gone. I was standing there, and he was on his way out, and I approached him, and I told him, he said, well, madam, all is gone, but you know what he did? He went in his car. He didn't let me leave without something, and he gone in his pocket, and, you know, he gives me some funds, and I hope he's listening. I just want to thank him for that. I'll never forget him. You know, he looked right into my face, and, you know, he said, I can't let this elderly lady walk away with nothing. He went in his pocket, and he, you know, he gave me, so he's listening. I want to say kudos to you, Mr. McCartney, you and your family. I'll never forget you. I love you, and may God continue to bless you.
Okay, that's a beautiful story. Thank you so much.
Yes.
We all need to be like that at Christmas and all year round. For people in need. Thank you so much for sharing that. Some of your messages here. This texter says, it needs to be distribution. What now? The police need to enforce that. Don't give them the license to have the event at one location. It reminds me of the public service motorcade where hundreds of public service workers packed in buses and trucks to create miles of planned gridlock, celebrating the fact that they weren't working. All done with a police escort. Right now, at times, dancing in the street to the consternation and frustration of people trying to get to work. Why do we promote such nonsense?
Oh, it depends on which side you are on. Because I was like, you're just trying to get to work at 12? It's like, okay, no. That sound like you're a public servant. But you meant it started early. Actually, you apparently had to be to work from 6 o'clock to get on the motorcade. Mm-hmm. And then it started around 9.
That was quite disruptive. But this one says, if I'm on the highway in traffic, how do the police know that I'm headed to the sports center? The only people on the side of the road are the people at the sports center. What? Pre-registration and distribution. You will know exactly how many people are coming and when they're coming. Oh, to make people register. That's interesting.
But once again, the thing is, you cannot avoid all issues. Because if you say pre-registration, then some people are like, oh, well, I didn't have access to a computer. It's too complicated. I didn't know. And then only a certain type of person who is computer savvy or has access to the internet or data is going to be the one to pre-register in time, right?
But you can get someone to help them.
Right. So at the end of the day,
you had to have a car. And not lot of people don't, right? For the last few years, you had to have a car.
Nobody has a car.
All we have is cars. We got more cars than people in this place.
I bet all of them was rentals. Bunch of degenerates.
Wait, no.
The degenerates who drive rentals. Sorry, I apologize. That has nothing to do with it.
I don't know if I'd say that word, but they're very...
What, cars? You're right.
Degenerates. But they are very interesting people, as we've said, especially hatchback rental car drivers.
The Marshes?
It's all hatchbacks. All of them. But yeah, you finished your point of me, Reed. This one says here, they need to have it in Andros. I would fix it. Oh, boy. Anyway. This person says, did I hear you say the minister says government can't do everything? They just know this all. All they have to do is make it easier for Bahamians, and we will do the rest. Thank God.
That's not true.
For the good ones who are giving.
That's not true.
Well, they could try to make it easier. Absolutely.
When you make it easier for, and every time I hear people say this, you just got to make it easier for businesses to thrive. Yeah, and then you do, and then you say, hey, I'd like to tax you. Then the business say, oh, you're trying to kill us. You're going to shut this country down. What you going to do with no gas? But
Scrooge, I don't know what's going on.
The thing is, let's not lie to ourselves, right? Mm-hmm. We might disagree with Mr. Munro on many a day, but he is correct in that line. The government cannot do it all, right? The government's job and responsibility is to do the things that we can't do on our own.
All right, let's take this call. Good morning, caller. You're on the air.
Hey, good morning, Dwight, and good morning, Steven.
Hi.
Good morning. Yeah, man, you know, I really hope next year, right, we don't see the scavenger hunt growing, getting bigger than it is, right? Because while people looking at it as give back, right? Mm-hmm. What about empowerment, right? What about what really upset me to see the prime minister on the stage, right, talking about giving back, right? Mr. Prime Minister, if you are listening, could you just give back to people their sovereign wealth fund, right? And then maybe that could cause that to become an opening for empowerment. Yes, we appreciate you made them millions, right? But dreaming people don't need to be living from a scavenger hunt situation every year, and it's just getting bigger. It's just showing you how poor the people are and how much poorer they are getting every year in this town, man. So please, Mr. Prime Minister, give us our sovereign wealth fund back, reenact it, and then maybe we wouldn't have to be seeing these scavenger hunts as we've seen. You guys have a nice day.
I don't think that would make any difference at all. It's just called something different. But okay, I hear you. I don't get either, but that's not going to change that. I can tell you that
the
now.
The sovereign wealth fund there?
I mean, that no matter what, there will always be this type of behavior, sadly.
No, it's not. But then,
there are tons of people who didn't need to be on that line. We know this.
So let's establish something, Dwight, right? The fact that you buy a present for your child on Christmas, and then somebody walks in and says, why you do that? You could have spent the money on textbooks. Doesn't mean that you didn't buy textbooks, right? Let us not complain for the sake of complaining, all right? If you have a separate point that you wish to make, by all means, make that point. If your point is, we need to get to a point of empowerment. Fine. But these people, once again, I don't like having to defend the number boys, but let us be truthful in our critique. Owen gives away grants every year for businesses, right? For small businesses, for crazy idea businesses, all these different things. That's a separate thing from this random give back, which is a separate thing from the Big Bang. We have to be fair in our critique. Otherwise, our critique will be thrown in the garbage. Right? Now we could say, oh, the government should tax them every year. Fine. We say, oh, they should diversify what they're doing. Okay, fine. Maybe they should split it up and put it in different locations. Fine. But we can't just randomly say empowerment. And then when they say the government isn't empowering people, Access Accelerator is on this station every month.
Mm-hmm. Twice.
Twice a month. Saying what you can do. Saying the programs that they're giving away for free. Saying the money that you could apply for. Almost every ministry has a grant. Now, I will grant you, it is difficult to get the silly people who are the directors and stuff to sign it in time. Mm-hmm. But that's neither here nor there.
No,
for us to say that there is no empowerment isn't true. That's a different conversation, Dwight.
All right, let me read these really quickly. We've got to go to a break.
I'm just saying, be fair in your critique, people. Otherwise, it will be ignored, not by me, but by the people who you want to listen to your critique.
Yeah. This texter says, the bombs government gave a very lucrative industry to a handful of individuals and decided to collect tax as opposed to instituting a national lottery like Powerball, et cetera, which funds education or whatever you want. These giveaways simply obscure the fact that they are approaching billionaire status at the country's expense. Schools, hospitals, clinics, teachers, nurses that were built or hired with the revenue generating from gambling. Look at the model in progressive countries as opposed to our society where major revenue generator is in the hand of a few.
Mm. That makes sense.
Yeah. This one says here, even though it was more organized, it was still a traffic nightmare for hours. It has outgrown the area. It has to be done on a weekend and not during the busiest time of the year. It looks like these folks are flexing their power and show that they
because it's PR,
have
guys.
More say than the general public.
Oh, well, they do. They do. Let's not fool ourselves. Mm. They definitely have more say than us.
Oh, boy. This one says it'll be good if they would do it using satellite shops, so it will assist the Family Island customers as well.
Mm. I'm sure they did something in the Family Islands, but yes, definitely. If they did it with satellite stuff, the people who live all the way out Gambia and Adelaide wouldn't have to drive four hours into town to get to it.
Okay.
Have you ever been to Gambia?
I have, of course. What do you mean? I'm just saying if you...
By boat or by plane?
You could. If you have the time ready for that and sit in the line for 5-6 hours, then I think you could be using your time in a way better way. But anyway, please stop lumping, Stephen, this is for you. Please stop lumping all businesses into your narrow category of the evil business. I guess you're
Did I say
folks.
Evil business today?
You said worse. As long as there are giveaways, there will always be people. Yeah, that is the truth.
Right.
This one says here, it's all marketing... and then they've said some other things I cannot read on the air.
That's probably all true.
This person says his Sunday is better and far out west would be better. Mm. Okay. So
no, it's not better to happen in one location anywhere.
Okay. Well, that's their problem. But disrupting, as the texter said, the days before Christmas on a work day.
Weekends would be slightly better, but it would be even better if it was dispersed and not in one location.
And if they don't want to do that, fine. But
and we tax them into oblivion.
Weekends would be better.
No, weekends are better.
Mm-hmm. So,
but imagine a weekend and not in one place. Mm. That would be even better.
It might have issues for them. I mean, I could think just controlling, making sure that people don't come back more than once or go to different places.
They have the money. Mm. This is where I'm going to pull that card.
Yeah,
they can do it.
Well. Even with that, still do it on the weekend. I said that you had to be in a car, but somebody said that they also were serving people on bicycles and motorbikes.
So vehicles.
Well, that's special. Let's take this call really quick, and then we've got to go to a break. Good morning, caller. You're on the air. Wow. Hi, whatever that is, turn that down, please. Thank you.
Is that you, Bumble?
Hi. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Dwight.
Hi.
Maybe you can help me. I'm a puzzle about person who sponsored the Junkanoo, right? Mm-hmm. Tell me, when someone sponsored Junkanoo, do you just advertise the sponsor, or do you give them seats or something like that? What is the gift?
I think some of them got tickets.
I think. Huh? Now, what do you mean, sponsor a group or sponsor the parade?
The parade. Because I was told something about sponsors having certain seats or something already covered,
yes,
or something like that.
Apparently, they got some seats. Yes, and they gave money.
So do they resell those seats or the employees or whatever? I'm trying to figure out how does it work.
It would be for.
I mean, we can't answer that.
No, I'm saying it would be for the business to do whatever they want to do with it.
That's their ticket. I can't imagine selling it. That would be horrible.
I mean,
That's what I'm thinking.
But it's up to them.
Yeah, but they're within their rights.
It was hard for us to get seats in the regular spot that we normally get by social bank area, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I don't know if they give them some of these seats or they can't sell them or whatever. I'm just trying to figure out, you know, how that operates, because I could hardly get no more seats.
Well, as we talked about yesterday with Dion Miller from the JCNP, it's online now, and you see how it works with online. You got to be up early. You got to be sitting by the computer, and as soon as it goes live, you got to get on. Sometimes it causes the system to crash, but that's how it works, and that's how it's going to be going forward, it seems. So that's just the nature of the game. All right, let's take a break. When we come back, a whole lot more on this Friday morning. It is Morning Blend on Guardian Radio 96.9. Stay with us. Grazia plena, Maria, grazia plena, Maria.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
I'm Rita Foley with an AP News Minute. There's a new look this morning at the toll the war is taking on those in Gaza. The Palestinian death toll there has surpassed 20,000, according to health officials in Gaza, which is run by Hamas. And the UN is among the agencies saying that more than 500,000 people in Gaza are starving. The AP's Norman Hall.
The humanitarian crisis follows Hamas's October 7th attack and the response by Israeli forces. The report warned that the risk of famine is increasing each day, blaming the hunger on insufficient aid entering Gaza. In the town of Rafah, located in the southern part of Gaza, where Israel has told Palestinians to seek shelter, there has been repeated bombardment of what Israel says are militant targets. I'm Norman Hall.
The AAA says 115 million of us will travel for the holidays. Most of us are driving, but airports are expected to be the busiest they've ever been over the Christmas and New Year travel period. I'm Rita Foley.
Whether you're looking for your first or new home, or even using your existing home as equity, RBC understands that your journey to home ownership is unique, and your mortgage financing should reflect that. That is why, at RBC, we have dedicated mortgage specialists that provide sound advice and helpful solutions to make your dream home a reality. Best of all, the RBC mortgage team is mobile, flexible, and will meet you almost anywhere. Visit rbc.com/take60seconds to connect with an RBC mortgage specialist.
You got your first look at traffic for the morning, brought to you by RBC. Get a no-fee RBC loan plus 5 chances to win up to $5,000. Not looking so bad right now throughout New Providence. These are the final days before Christmas, and it's going to be... You're going to need your patience, folks, and slow down. And there are a lot of people in town who are not familiar with our streets, and they are a nightmare near the roundabout, so keep that in mind. We'll give you another update, though, after the 8 o'clock news. Stay with us. Traffic brought to you by RBC. Learn more at rbc.com/Caribbean/Christmas cash.
Enjoy the magic of Christmas.
at Nassau Cruise Port all December long. Visit Santa and his helpers at Santa's Workshop for holiday photos. Enjoy Christmas caroling, wreath decorating, mixology classes, and movie marathons. And of course, come for the great concerts and holiday shopping. Nassau Cruise Port is your ultimate destination for Christmas fun. Visit NassauCruiseport.com and follow us on Facebook and Instagram for details. Nassau Cruise Port, the place to be.
There's a new electric vehicle in town. The Jack brand of SUVs, trucks, sedans, and commercial vans, available only at Easy Car Sales, home of the fully electric vehicle. For a powerful, smooth ride at a fraction of the cost, the pump behind and hit the road with Jack. Visit easy242.com to see our brand new Jack models and drop into Easy Car Sales for a test drive. It'll have you singing. Hit the road with Jack and don't you pump gas no more.
We are back here with Morning Blend on Guardian Radio 96.9. Dwight Strachan along with Stephen Hanna. And if you are a regular listener to Guardian Radio, you know that this week it was a sad day. Tuesday night, the doctor is in final episode. For now. Dr. D. Archer, the host of this long-running program, is joining us this morning. Dr. D., good morning. Great to have you on Morning Blend.
Good morning, Dwight. Thank you for having me.
All right, so let the people know what happened, why the decision.
Oh, wow, Dwight. You know, it's a really good run. People don't realize how long I was really doing the show, and I'll hold on to that because I do have a trivia. But, you know, things change a lot. Times change. I have a two-year-old. There's a lot of things going on. I've made a lot of changes. I think one thing that I've even mentioned on the show is that the last few years I've had an opportunity to reflect on a lot of things and how our lives need to be and where we need to have priorities. And I think I'm going to just try and do it in another way and then take a little bit of a break from the radio for just a little bit. But there are some physical projects that I want to do. I talk a lot about change and, you know, how do we improve the healthcare system? And I think I have some work to do on the ground that I really need to get into.
Okay. All right. So as we talked about, the door is open. So when you are ready to make that return, you let us know.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dwight. Yeah, I appreciate that. And I definitely appreciate you. Like I tell everybody, an evening medical show, Dwight was like, huh? But when we looked at what we were doing, you were fully on board and very supportive. So I want to thank you and Guardian Radio for the time that I've spent here, and hopefully we can do things together in the future. You know, I don't think this is the end, but just the beginning.
Excellent, excellent. Now, there's something you wanted to do for your listeners that you didn't get to do on Tuesday's broadcast. Tell us about that.
Oh, yeah. So, and I had some people call me. I was just going to do a trivia, a little giveaway. I kind of do it most Christmases. I think it's a good way to just kind of like, you know, get the ball rolling, give something to people during the Christmas season. I heard you guys talking about giving. I also have mixed feelings about it, but I think, you know, certain times it's good to give, just give purely. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that, but I also believe in, you know, teaching a man to fish. And so I usually do a trivia at the end of the year. I didn't get to do it on that night show. It went very quickly. I started getting people calling in. And, of course, I had some listeners remind me I didn't do the trivia. So I wanted to complete that, you know, on my way out.
Okay. So you're going to do it here this morning on Morning Blend.
Yes.
All right. So you're going to do
it's a trivia question. It's a very, very simple question, right? It's two parts. How many years was the show The Doctor's In, me, Dr. D, on air? And who was my first official guest? And what did we talk about? Well, even if they don't get the last right, if they can get at least two parts, that would be great. And then for those persons who follow me online, if you like my Facebook page, The Doctor's In With Me, Dr. D, I'm going to post a question there too. And so you'll also get a chance to win something. And right now we're going to give away $100. I mean, it's Christmas time. People probably just want cash.
Okay. All right. So we want the first person to call in with the correct answer. and they will get the prize. All right. So call us. Call us right now. 323-6232 or 325-4316.
Hello.
You can even call. Is that somebody calling in? Or you can call us even toll free 242-300-5720 if you know the answer. We got a call right now, Dr. D. Let's see if this person's going to get it. Is in on, and who was the first guest? And I guess you get a little bonus points if you know what they were talking about. Caller, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Dwight. Good morning, Stephen. Good morning, the doctor. Compliments of the season to you. I'm going to take a guess. Was it like 3 years in Dr. Sands?
Ah, so close. I won't tell you which one is right and which one is wrong.
Okay. Can I?
But very, very close, Dr. Sands. Caller. Very close. I have to say that. And I think I know who this is. Okay. So a very close, but not quite.
All right. Thank you. I'll try and get him the
okay.
Yes.
All right. Thank you very much. All right, so we're going to go to the news, and you keep calling in after the news, and we'll get your name and number to Dr. D so you all can connect. But Dr. we thank you so much for being with us, and again, we wish you all the best, and hopefully we'll talk again soon. Are you there?
Thank you very much, Dwight, and I'll see everybody. I'm still at Medical Concierge Services, so people can reach out to me there if they need to.
Okay, thanks again. Thank you so much. Keep calling in, folks. All right, we'll be back after the news.
Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Welcome back to Morning Blend here on Guardian Radio 96.9. We are streaming live on guardiantalkradio.com and on the Guardian Radio app for smart devices. We're also on your televisions on Cable Bahamas, Channel 969, and BTC Flow, Channel 612. You can tweet us at Morning Blend 969 or facebook.com/morningblend969 on the Guardian Radio text line powered by BTC 422-4796. Standard text rate supply. And at 8:21, it is time for another check of your weather for today, brought to you by Easy Car Sales. Here's what's happening. We've got high pressure still the dominant weather feature. It's going to be influencing the weather for the next few days, and that's going to create moderate to fresh breezes over the country. Small craft operators should not venture far from port, and beachgoers are advised to remain on shore due to high seas, rough surf, and dangerous rip currents, especially along northern and eastern shorelines. For all areas today, expect variably cloudy, mild, and breezy conditions with spotty showers through tonight. Small craft operators advised, again, not to venture far from port due to swells. Temperatures today, we're looking at highs getting up to 77 Fahrenheit, 25 Celsius. Overnight lows tonight getting down to about 68 Fahrenheit, 20 Celsius. In your extended outlook, high pressure will continue to impact the islands with moderate to fresh breezes, but the winds are expected to shift east to southeasterly late Sunday, and that could mean more rain as we get closer to Christmas and Boxing Day. So look for more moisture and warmer temperatures for the holiday weekend. So, for Saturday, partly cloudy to cloudy and breezy with isolated showers. Again, small craft operators advised not to venture far from port. Then Sunday, Christmas Eve, partly cloudy to cloudy and breezy with isolated showers. We'll have more on what to expect on Christmas Day and Boxing Day. So for those days, again, rain chances going up a bit. Sunday, about 6% rain chance, but that does change on Monday, Christmas Day, to about 24%. And leading into Boxing Day, about 22%. So could be a chance for showers. Heading to the Junkanoo Parade, you might want to take an umbrella. Maybe. But we'll see. That's your Morning Blend weather check. Brought to you by Easy Car Sales. Unleash the power of electricity. Test drive an electric vehicle at Easy Car Sales and discover the instant torque, quiet ride, and the power of an EV. Visit easy242.com and plug into the evolution of transportation. Another check of traffic for this morning brought to you by RBC. Visit rbc.com/Caribbean for more information. In your real-time traffic at this hour, we're seeing just a bit of congestion on Mile Butler Highway, just north of Harold Pond. You'll see that there for you. On your way to the roundabout, Tawny Williams Darling Highway, northbound. Elsewhere, not looking so bad. Gladstone Road, just near Munnings Road, you'll see some traffic in front of you if you're northbound heading toward JFK Drive. Building traffic on Blue Hill Road just north of Soldier on the way to the roundabout Independence Drive. And we've got a bit of congestion downtown near the Straw Market on Bay Street if you're heading eastbound. Robinson Road near Old Trail and East West Highway. That light is not working after it was knocked down, and so there's some congestion there if you're heading westbound, and building traffic on Marathon Road northbound at this hour. That's what we're looking at right now. That's your real-time traffic and your Morning Blend traffic alert brought to you by RBC. Learn more at rbc.com/Caribbean.
The National Insurance Insurance Board encourages all employers and self-employed persons to stay ahead of the 2024 rush by scheduling a meeting with your inspector today. A one-on-one appointment with your inspector ensures that your account is up to date and compliant, making it a hassle-free process when applying for your tax compliance certificates and business license renewals with the Department of Inland Revenue. Stay ahead, avoid delays. Keep your business thriving. Contact your inspector now. Your success is our priority.
You've tried everything. ASUS, with your mother's cousin's sister's auntie, and even hiding your money under your mattress. But is your money safe? Your Bahamian dollar deposit in a member bank or credit union is insured up to $50,000. If anything happens, your deposit up to the insured value will be returned to you thanks to Deposit Insurance. Visit Deposit Insurance Corporation at www.dic.bs.
Protection for your money guaranteed with DIC.
Tis the season for sharing with loved ones and friends, and a time for reflection on the year soon to end. But before this year ends and the new has to be gone, this world would share a gift too, though it be only one. For trusting our services in projects great or small, we thank you for stopping by or giving us a call. As we bid farewell to this year at its end, should we not meet tomorrow or on the other days round the bend, have a happy Christmas and a safe celebration till we meet again next year for another collaboration.
We're back here with Morning Blend on Guardian Radio 96.9. Dwight Strachan along with Stephen Hanna. Coming up in a few minutes, we're going to be talking with Nasser Cruiseport. They've got Phil Stubbs in concert. This is going to be a good one, folks. In January 13th. And they're going to tell us what we can expect. That's coming up in just a few minutes here. All right, so we want to continue with the trivia. Dr. D's trivia. If you can get the answer, you can win that money. If you have the answer, give us a call, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. Call us toll-free, 242-300-5720. She's asking how long was the doctor is in, how many years was the doctor is in on Guardian Radio, and who was the first guest? If you have the answer, you'll win, she said, $100. Hey, a good morning caller, do you have the answer?
Is it 10 years?
What's the other answer? The other part to the...
Dr. Dwayne's son?
You're not correct. Not correct. All right. So keep trying. Keep trying. 323-6232. 325-4316. 325-4259. Tweet us, Facebook us, text us. 4224. Actually, I don't know why I'm saying that because you can't text in. You've got to call to win. You've got to call to win. So call in, and you could have that money just in time for Christmas, eh? Yeah, so that sounds pretty good. And she said, you know, some of the callers have been pretty close, but no cigar. So call in. I see people texting. You really do need to call. So just call. Call right now. And
yeah, the Texas got it right?
Boy. Couple. What should we do with that? Should we give it to... No, we don't want to do that. Call him. Text her. Call in. 323-6232. 325-4316. 325-4259. All right, that'll be the easiest money you've ever won, I'm sure. Good morning. You're on the air. Oh, nope. Okay. Yep, let's take this one. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi, good morning. Is it 10 years, Dr. Robin Roberts?
No, that's not correct. All right. Let's get this call in. Good morning. Do you have the answer to the trivia question?
Dwight Strachan, how are you? Good morning and compliments to the season.
Same to you. Same to you.
It was 5 years and Dr. Sanz was the first guest.
There you go. There you go. We have a winner. We have a winner. All right. Stay on the line. Give the producer your name and number and we'll connect you with Dr. D. And you've won yourself $100. 5 years and Dr. Dwayne Sands. Do you by any chance know what they were talking about?
Say it again, Dwight.
Do you remember what they were talking about?
I can't remember the subject matter, but I listen to her and I just like her show. I like your show. Sometimes you're a little bit biased. Even so, it's a little bit more safe than you.
Oh, my God. Safe.
So,
mm-hmm. mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, you know, I keep up. I like to listen, too, so I can be educated on some issues.
I appreciate it. I'm glad that you called in. I called in for Christmas, but you wanted, I know. I'm glad
okay,
that you
Dwight,
it
and I want to wish the nation and everyone a beautiful, and have a very, very, enjoy your Christmas with your family. You have enough football on to watch. You have Junkanoo. You need not to get in any problems this Christmas.
Absolutely. Stay on the line. Stay on the line to give your number and name, and we'll get you in contact with Dr. D, and congratulations.
Okay.
Thank you very much. 5 years in Dr. Twain Sands. So, again, we wish Dr. D. Archer all the best, and it was a great run. Okay. So, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we're going to find out about the Phil Stubbs concert at Nassau Cruise Port, January 13th. All the details coming up. And
which
then later.
Which hit song will he be performing?
All, hopefully. All, because he's got a whole lot. That concert could go on for five to 10 hours, maybe 5 years. Right? So we'll see. And then later, folks, Bristol Wines and Spirits will be here with us in business coming up at 9. So we've got a lot more Morning Blend coming up for you after this break. Stay with us.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining. Till he appeared.
Twas the heights of the season. Scotiabank wanted to give the people a lift for mom, dad, and kids. Apply for a Scotiaplan loan and unwrap your home, buy new appliances, or go on vacation. Scotiabank is giving holiday cheer with an all-expense-paid weekend trip for two to Miami for 3 days and two nights. When you apply for a Scotiaplan loan from now until December 31st, enjoy low interest rates and no payments for up to 2 months. Unwrap the perfect Christmas with Scotiabank.
Test results. Do you want the good news or the bad news first?
Good news! No, wait, bad news. Give it to me straight, doctor.
Your blood work came back. You've got erythrocytes all over.
Oh no, this can't be happening.
Here's the good news. That just means red blood cells. It's a good thing. You're completely fine.
With 99% of medical claims paid in 5 days, we're like a doctor who doesn't want to be a comedian. CG Atlantic, medical in life. Good like that.
Power on the holidays this Christmas with Custom Computers. We have everything that everyone wants to see under the tree. Laptops, iPads, AirPods, Apple Watches, Bluetooth speakers, and more. Find gifts for every reason this Christmas season at Custom Computers. Visit us on Patton Street in Palmdale opposite Liquid Courage or in Caves Village through the Blake Road entrance. The best Christmas has to offer is right here at your one-stop shop, Custom Computers.
My granny always said prevention is better than cure. I remember this every time I think of ransomware and my business. Ransomware is a form of malware that provides criminals with the ability to lock a computer from a remote location and then display a pop-up window informing the user that it will not be unlocked until a sum of money is paid. Don't be held at ransom. Have effective and updated internet security software and firewall running before going online. Never reply to or click on links in spam emails from companies or individuals you do not know. Remember, when it comes to ransomware, prevention is better than cure. Stop ransomware. Visit GetSafe.com.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
A demanding wife. Let me tell you about his miserable life. Mr. Gopher was his name. Trying to please his wife almost drove him insane. Every morning she wake up,
Gopher this and Gopher that.
Till sundown hear a chat,
got her on this, got her on that.
Oh my, for goodness sake,
Gopher this and Gopher that.
I get so tired I need a break,
got her on this, got her on that.
your spouse. Do your duty, cause I ain't gonna starve. Yes, my name is Mrs. Carter Have. Every morning she wake up,
go for this and go for that.
Till sundown, hear a chat,
gotta run this, gotta run that.
Oh, my, for goodness sake,
go for this and go for that.
I get so tired, I need a break,
gotta run this, gotta run that.
We're battling, we're trying to figure out which of the many Phil Stubb songs to play, but that one is the one that we went with. Go for it. Yeah. Phil Stubbs in concert January 13th at the Nassau Cruise Port. Welcome back to Morning Blend on Guardian Radio. Dwight Stromo with Stephen Hanna joining us to tell us about this from the Nassau Cruise Port. Very pleased to have back with us Amanda Friedman and Ed Fields. Good morning. Season's greetings to both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. We got to get Phil Stubbs on the show at one at some point. Well, that'll be great. I'd love to talk to him. But this is wonderful. Tell us about this, how this has come about, and what we can expect.
Well, January 13th, Phil Stubbs will be performing at the Nassau Cruise Port Amphitheater. And, you know, tickets are on sale. Lord, the site escapes me now, but I'm sure Amanda will remember.
BahamasMeTickets.com.
There you go. BahamasMeTickets.com. And also they'll be available, you know, at the gate online, though. It will be a cashless event. So, yeah, we're just really proud to have Phil on. He is an icon. You know, there are very few artists who are as prolific as he is anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And essentially, you know, he's just a great storyteller and at the same time, good music that goes with those stories. So we're very happy to have him, Dwight.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so let's clarify that. Just you said it's a cashless event. So can you buy tickets at the door? Can you buy tickets at the door?
Right. I mean, we will be set up so that if you come to the door, you can buy tickets online. You know, not with cash sales.
Okay.
So you know, bring your we want people to buy tickets in advance. That's what we really want people to do, you know, makes it a smoother process for everyone. But it also, you know, we try to be as cashless as we can at the port as well in terms of food and beverage, et cetera. So,
right.
The food and beverage they'll accept cash, but we try to focus on a cashless environment, which also adds a bit of security and safety for everyone.
All right. So how long have the tickets been on sale now, and how many people can you accommodate for the concert?
Well, we can accommodate up to 3,500 people, standing room, but we're going to have we're going to have a VIP section, which will be pods, which we will announce later, which will be groups of 10, and those tickets will go on sale very soon. And then we also have VIP section where there will be kind of a first-come, first-served seating with along with tables, et cetera, but they'll be closer to the stage. And then, of course, we have general admission, which is $50. And that's where we encourage you to bring your blankets or your seats or, you know, your fold-out chairs and just to relax for the evening. You know, in there, no kind of the setup.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a really comfortable environment for people.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. How are the sales going so far?
They're pretty good. I mean, you know, the thing is, you know, I mean, Dwight, this is a thing that promoters in the Bahamas have to overcome. And that is Bahamians do not do anything in advance. They wait for the last minute. You know, some say, you know, it's government payday. I'm not necessarily buying that kind of thing, but they wait for the last minute, and then all of a sudden, in the week of, you just see this mass rush of sales. So that is what we expect. So you know, we it's very difficult for promoters in the country because it's hard for them to gauge, you know, how to go about, you know, planning. But it's a risk they all have to take.
Yeah. Wow. All right. So we're gonna get back to tickets in a bit. There are other people performing that night as well, right? Tell us about that.
Yeah, Iris Storr and Nishi LS. You know them all. You know them. I mean, this is what we're doing in this show is basically all the performers can only do original Bahamian songs.
Ooh.
So you know, there are a lot of songs out there that people think are original Bahamian songs, mm-hmm. but they aren't.
Right.
In one of the most popular songs, Tell All I Need, is not a Bahamian song.
Yeah.
Most people don't know that, but they think it is, right? Because it was adapted.
Mm-hmm.
But we're focusing heavily and only, you know, especially in honor of Phil, because Phil is strictly original.
Absolutely.
Right? So Ira and Nishi LS will be also Bahamian, performing Bahamian original songs.
Yeah, that's great. What time does it start?
Show starts at 8 o'clock. The doors will probably open around about 6:30, 7 o'clock. And Nishi Ellis will go on for about a half hour, then us for an hour, and then, of course, we'll have the great Phil Stubbs. So it'll be a wonderful evening. And by the way, the Phil is going to be backed up by Fred Ferguson on the ticket.
Oh, wow. Okay. This is going to be great. All right. So there are ticket outlets as well. Is that right?
Not right now.
Right now.
It's just
okay.
Amazon.com. So if we do expand the ticket outlets, we will certainly advertise that.
Excellent. And we'll come back with a reminder about this in a bit. But Amanda, tell us more about what's been happening during this holiday period at the cruise port.
Yeah, so what we've been doing this December is really trying to drive excitement and Christmas spirit and joy and activity in our space. So we've had several events throughout the month of December. Tonight, we're really wrapping up our event lineup in terms of large-scale activations with our Christmas movie marathon. So this was actually postponed from the 15th. We had some bad weather, We made the decision to postpone it. And we had such great feedback on social media from people that really wanted to attend and bring their family. So we decided rather than cancel it, let's postpone it. We put it to tonight. And so that is a ticketed event. It's $5 entry. Kids 2 and under are free. But it's at the amphitheater, and it's going to begin at 5 p.m. The first movie screening starts at 5:30. And we're going to show 3 movies back to back. We're there until 11 p.m. tonight. And it's going to be a wonderful time. Very nice and comfortable for families. It's kind of like a walk-in movie experience. And it should be a really great time for everybody that comes out.
So, you know, everyone's asking, which movies are you showing?
Happy to share that. Mm-hmm. So we start off with Elf, you know, something that is really great for our kids. And it's more of a newer Christmas. And then we're going to The Grinch Who Stole Christmas, which, again, is another classic. And then we're wrapping it up with Home Alone. For us millennials that grew up watching that, we're wrapping it up with that. So we're kind of starting from earliest and getting back to the classics as we get later into the evening. And we're very excited. We think it's a wonderful lineup, and it should be a wonderful time.
Excellent. Again, what time is that?
Doors open at 5, and then we're going to go until 11 p.m. So the first movie screening starts promptly at 5:30. So we encourage everybody to get on down to the amphitheater beginning at 5 p.m. tonight. And we'll have concessions on sale. Tickets are also available through BahamasEtickets.com now. So you can purchase them online. You will be able to purchase with card at the door, and we are making a provision for cash sales at the door. So, as I would have said, our preference is, of course, card, but there will be provisions to buy tickets at the door tonight for you and your family.
Excellent. Any other things happening between now and January 13th?
Yeah, so as we go through Christmas, we are open. The port is open to shop and dine. We are absolutely open to the public. We're still publicizing that fact and, you know, inviting everybody to come on down to Nassau Cruise Port, see the brand new redeveloped waterfront, see all of our wonderful tenants and vendors, and really experience what we have going on, because the shopping is incredible. It's a one-stop shop. You can grab something from Bamboo Shack, grab a drink from Island Post or Gallery and Wine Bar, and just shop with all of our wonderful tenants. And that's going to be happening straight through to Christmas Eve. We'll actually be open till 9 p.m. With our holiday shopping hours. And then after that, we're really just ready and raring to go for Phil. The other thing is, while we lead up to Christmas and until Christmas Eve, we'll have Santa in Paradise as well. He'll be there every day, and there'll be several days throughout as we lead into Christmas. And we're very excited. We want everybody to come on down.
Excellent. Sounds great. And with the concert on the 13th, concessions, you did mention that, Amanda. Tell people about what they can expect if they come out there, what they'd be able to purchase.
Yeah, so we'll have our tenants will be open for Phil Stubbs. There will be food and drink available for purchase there. And, you know, it's going to be a wonderful night. You know, the people are going to want to come out, experience this wonderful Bahamian music from legends like Phil Stubbs. And, you know, just come on down. Bring your family, bring your friends, bring everyone, and buy your tickets early.
Yeah. All right. Anything else people need to keep in mind about this? Maybe if they're concerned about parking, what do they need to know?
Well, so, you know, the good thing is we've had many concerts there now. And like John Canoe, people find their parking. There is lots and lots of parking downtown, especially in the evening. And so we have not had any difficulty. As you know, one of the largest concerts we've had is Taurus Riley. And certainly that didn't present an issue for anyone. I think it's also, I want to really highlight one thing, and that is for Bahamians still haven't gotten the message that the port is open, wide open for anyone to come into at any time that it is open. Mm. So please, you know, this is not you know, a restricted area in any way, shape, or form. And this is also a really wonderful time to buy some last-minute Christmas gifts, because they have some really wonderful products there that I'm sure people would like, because a lot of authentic gifts for Christmas. So
any specific?
Also, this Saturday, Dwight, mm-hmm. is One Blood. I don't want to forget people to forget that on Saturday is One Blood at the Nassau Cruise Board concert that Concepts does every year.
Tell us more about that.
Well, I we're not the promoters of that. We're just certainly the venue. Mm-hmm. But it's a reggae, you know, it's a reggae-based event that happens twice a year, put on by Concept Marketing, and that's I think starting at 9 on Saturday. If I'm correct, right, Amanda?
That's correct. Yeah.
Okay. Excellent. Excellent. Any specific hours for these few days leading up to Christmas and maybe Christmas and Boxing Day? Tell us about how that works.
We're running holiday shopping hours until Christmas Eve, so the port will be open until 9 p.m. Like Ed would have said, we are absolutely open to the public. It's not just for Christmas, too. It's the year-round. But really, you can find great gift items from the wonderful tenants in Nassau Cruise Port. So come on down. There's lots of light. There's security. There's parking on bay, like Ed would have said. So just make a plan and come on down.
All right. Sounds good. One more time, remind people about January 13th, the concert with Phil Stubbs.
Yes, so that's January 13th. That's Saturday. Phil Stubbs, the concert starts at 8 o'clock. And listen, what can I say? You know, there are some things that you just don't need to talk much about. I mean, obviously, right after the new year, we're going to bring Phil out, and he's going to start talking about the show and all that. But and you guys are going to be promoting it. We're partnered with The Guardian Radio to get the word out there. So, you know, it's just one of those things where, especially right after Christmas, you know, people kind of have like a little lull. Mm-hmm. And this will be the second week in January after you manage to catch yourself a little bit. And there'll be time to listen. Let's bring in the new year with Phil Stubbs.
It sounds wonderful. Sounds wonderful. Thank you so much for being here and telling us about it again. Hopefully we'll talk more about it in the next few weeks. Ed Fields, Amanda Friedman, thank you, thank you, thank you again. Merry Christmas to both of you and your families. And looking forward to Phil Stubbs on January 13th.
Take care, Mary.
Thank you.
Take care. Christmas.
All right.
Merry Christmas. Thanks for having us.
Our pleasure. Our pleasure. All right. We're going to take a break. Listen to more Phil Stubbs as we go to the break. This is Morning Blend on Guardian Radio 96.9.
They bake it down home. Outside in the Dutch oven down home. Wrapped in banana leaves down home. Them rake and scrape boys will excite you. On weekends they play at the neighbor's bar. They'll make you dance down home. They'll send you in a trance down home. You'll shuffle your feet down home. Cause the rake and scrape so sweet down home.
At RBC, we know Now buying your new ride is a very personal experience with many decisions to make. That's why we leave the car choice to you and ask that you leave the rest to one of our RBC Auto Finance specialists trained to provide sound advice and helpful solutions to make your dream car a reality. The RBC Auto Finance team is mobile, flexible, and will meet you almost anywhere. Visit rbc.com/lovemyride to connect with an RBC Auto Finance specialist in your area.
My granny always said prevention is better than cure. I remember this every time I think of ransomware and my business. Ransomware is a form of malware that provides criminals with the ability to lock a computer from a remote location and then display a pop-up window informing the user that it will not be unlocked until a sum of money is paid. Don't be held at ransom. Have effective and updated internet security software and firewall running before going online. Never reply to things in spam emails from companies or individuals you do not know. Remember, when it comes to ransomware, prevention is better than cure. Stop ransomware. Visit getsafeonline.bs to find out more.
The National Insurance Board encourages all employers and self-employed persons to stay ahead of the 2024 rush by scheduling a meeting with your inspector today. A one-on-one appointment with your inspector ensures that your account is up to date and compliant, making it a hassle-free process when applying for your tax compliance certificates and business license renewals with the Department of Inland Revenue. Stay ahead, avoid delays. Keep your business thriving. Contact your inspector now. Your success is our priority.
This holiday season, Scotiabank brings you closer to the heart-pounding excitement of Junkanoo. Imagine yourself amidst the vibrant colors, lively music, energy of the Bahamas' most spectacular parade. With your Scotiacard MasterCard debit, every purchase is a ticket to a VIP adventure. Spend $500 or more and get a chance to win a VIP ticket, New Year's and Boxing Day Junkanoo. Promotion runs December 1st through 22nd. Visit vs.scotiabank.com for more details. Conditions apply.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman, we'll pretend that he is Parson Brown. You'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man, but you can do the job.
Welcome back to Morning Blend here on Guardian Radio 96.9. Dwight Straw along with Stephen Hanna, who's everything that the Grinch would be except for green. Trying to figure out what's going on. What did Christmas do to you, sir?
Nothing.
I don't understand it. We're going to figure it out, though. We're going to figure it out. All right, so let's talk about the... And this, I know you love to talk about this. Let's go through these things, the themes that we're going to see. I was impressed by some today, but I want to get, I know you're a very critical viewpoint on these. All right, so let's go through them. It's all in today's NASA Guardian. You got to pick up today's NASA Guardian to get your copy of the booklet, the Junkanoo Corporation of New Providence booklet on the Boxing and New Year's Day parades. Is the Junkanoo Synopsis Special for 2023-2024. And so you got everything in there about the order and what the pieces are and information about the banners. This is like great information, the collector's item, a keepsake for the parades. So when you're watching it, whether you're in person or watching on television, you'll know everything. You'll know more than the commentators and coming on about what this is that we're going to see. All right, so the theme, one family's theme for Boxing Day. Who are we, the greatest show on earth?
Is that a question and an answer?
There's no question mark. There's no punctuation. But who are we, the greatest show on earth? I guess it is, you could say.
What do you mean there's... Right. It has to be a question.
You're overthinking it.
No.
But who are we, the greatest show on earth? So, who are we, the greatest show on earth? Fine. Question answered. Bam. So, again, this is says, every year, thousands of Bahamians gather in the twilight hours on Boxing Day and New Year's Day to celebrate the glory and power of our people, even before we became free men and women. On our turbulent journey across the Atlantic, the spirit of Junkanoo danced in our souls. It is the glue that binds us all together. It is the spine of the nation's body and the greatest gift ever to be passed down by our ancestors and what we call the greatest show on earth. This Boxing Day, one family Junkanoo and community organization presents Who Are We? The Greatest Show on Earth. This Boxing Day, come and celebrate with us where we recognize and pay tribute to the people and groups that paved the way for this great and sacred art we call Junkanoo. An iconic journey through the years as we tell the story of our people. Okay. So they're going to be like highlighting a lot of the people from competing groups. So that's going to be interesting. That's unique, I think. I've not heard anything like that any time that I can remember. What do you think of their theme?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Really? All right. We're just going to focus on Boxing Day for this. Maybe next week we might look at New Year's. Next week. Valley Boys, they're going to do Once Upon a Time, a collection of classical fairy tales. I think you were listening to the show yesterday when I asked if it's going to be the European fairy tales. But let's see. It says, from beautiful princesses, eek, wicked queens. Well, aren't they
so
all?
Can we establish the fact that, anyway, whatever. You know what? Let me not attack people this early in the morning.
Let me read this and then you can say it. Say it.
That is not fairy tales?
Well, wicked queens, elves, monsters, and goblins to giants, glass slippers, poison apples, magic keys, and mirrors, the characters and images of fairy tales have cast a spell over readers and audiences, both adults and children, for centuries. These fantastic stories have traveled across cultural borders and have been passed on from generation to generation, ever-changing, renewed with each retelling. Few forms of literature have greater power to enchant us and rekindle our imagination than a fairy tale. This is Once Upon a Time, a portrayal of classical fairy tales. Join us as we explore a multitude of tales through the ages, their different manifestations in books, the stage, and the screen. Come with us on a walk through the enchanted world of fairy tales and fables, no matter the age, from 1 to 100. Here you can take a magical journey filled with adventure or just remember what it feels like to be a kid again. And there's a whole lot more. So as we figured yesterday, it's going to be more of the Disney type fairy tales, European ones, but hey,
once again, you're not right, because then Aladdin is not European, and
mentioned Aladdin.
These are see Aladdin now, the magic carpet ride is number four.
Okay,
but also the
but mainly
the issue it, with it is that this is when something has been commodified, right? There are people...
Thinking too deeply about this.
It's not looking too deeply in it. This is the reason why we'll complain and say, how come everybody doesn't know this thing? Because somebody kept repeating something else and didn't realize that's not what the thing was.
Okay. You're taking out all the fun.
As it
taking out all the fun.
If you're going to give points to something, then... Let's give points.
It might surprise us. All right.
Well, we'll see.
On Boxing Day, the Music Makers are still around. They are doing Expressions of Love, Dorian's Aftermath. They're saying that in our Boxing Day 2023 presentation, we highlight the positive contributions of domestic and foreign agencies that genuinely gave assistance to our country. This is what? What is this? This is Junkanoo. After the horrific effects of Hurricane Dorian, this is a downer, both local and global humanitarian efforts made it possible for those misplaced by the hurricane to have access to food. What? Well, that's certainly a different theme. Certainly different.
What songs will they play? Probably just like funeral it is finished. March. Yeah, just a constant funeral music. And that's fine. Whatever. True God.
Nobody want to hear that on Christmas?
You know, here's the thing. It's a Saturnalian festival. And,
stop.
And so,
stop it.
With that said, it is a chance for people to get out. You know, to express these pent-up emotions and thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
This is the safe space for them to do that. Wow. So go ahead.
Wow. Okay. Roots on Boxing Day. Lights, camera, action. They're saying, let's go to the movies. Let's celebrate the stars, from Western movies to thrillers, from action to comedy, from sci-fi to romance. Roots invites you to join us for a night at the movies. Cowboy heroes, cops and robbers, glamour and strife. Bigger than life, sitting in the darkness, what a world to see. Anything you can imagine, songs and romance. Life is a dance, sitting in the darkness. Again, popcorn on your knee. Grab your popcorn, a snack, and a drink, and read.
Life is a darkness.
That's what? Roots welcomes you to the movies. Welcome to the stars. Welcome to the grand illusion. All is yours right on Bay Street. Every plot is different. This we guarantee. Let's go to the movies.
There's something subversive about this description, all right? Where I feel like it's political satire. It's like, welcome to the grand illusion. That's how I interpreted it. Also, the lead costumes
that indicates the darkness within your soul.
Clearly. Coming to America and Cleopatra,
That's the lead costumes?
Have you ever gotten the feeling that the costumes are made first and then somebody's like, now how can we tie these all together?
Okay. Genesis, Boxing Day. They're still around? The Genesis Warhawks present Who's Hungry? Who's Hungry? Who's Hungry? This Boxing Day, the Genesis Warhawks tempts your palate as we tour the culinary landscape of the Bahamas. We love a good home-cooked meal. We know, what is your issue? What is your problem? Are you okay?
Buddy!
But we know Bahamians love to dine out almost as much.
Now, here's the thing. Before you continue reading, Dwight, if their costumes are things like this person is a giant conch fritter.
Oh, okay.
A giant conch fritter.
Right, right.
A bowl of guinea corn grits, right? You know, things that are Bohemian.
Maybe people eating them. Right? That might be easier too.
But I have a feeling, though.
Maybe they'll be dancing with the bowls.
Because here's the thing. Those things are very difficult to sculpt.
Can you do junk new choreographed dancing without spilling your sauce?
Yeah, no, but I think these are very difficult to sculpt that thing. How can you make something look like a bowl of stewed fish without it just being a brown lump?
This is where the creativity comes into play.
I'm
sir.
Waiting for you to
it's
get to.
It's going to be amazing.
Look at the off-the-shoulder costumes.
Okay, I'll get to that, but let me finish reading. Visit some of your favorite spots where you can satisfy your hunger, quench your thirst, and cater to your sweet tooth. We all love to eat. Therefore, the Warhawks invite Bahamians near and far to tap into their inner foodie and take this journey as with us as we present Who's Hungry? Things We Like to Eat. Oh, boy. Our banner will showcase the artisans who prepare some of your favorite meals. A down-home Bahamian chef. An Asian chef. What? And a pastry chef. Lead costume. This is the part you're talking about. Coming off to Christmas Day from our table to yours, our lead costume will portray that scrumptious Christmas dinner that we'd have just enjoyed with some special guests.
Yeah, because a turkey and ham is easy to sculpt. But it's very hard to sculpt actual Bahamian food.
Well, this may be a learning
the experience. The off-the-shoulder dances will feature a myriad of dining experiences, a.k.a. logos. See Wendy's, Subway, McDonald's, or Burger King.
This is what I asked yesterday. This is a way to work in all the sponsors you got. Hey, if you give us a buddy, we'll put your logo on a costume.
Bush Cook.
It's kind of weird.
Checkers.
Prime, clearly somebody was
Prime One, what? I Dream of Sugar, Big House, or Sweet Mouth.
Yeah, so this is.
I hope that these are product placements. I pray to the Lord that these are product placements.
They should have come to us. We could have put some Guardian Radio cookies out there. I don't know.
Please stop.
Okay. Anyway, that's interesting. It may be quite a revelatory. Anyway, Shell Saxon Superstars for Boxing Day.
Legendary
ancient rulers.
All hail King Rama.
The legendary article birthed from the cradle of civilization called forth to bring renaissance to all of humanity. Okay, from the belly of formation, a strange and wonderful range of fascinating kings and queens ruling across most of Russia, China, Africa, and Norway.
It's nothing like when somebody right-clicks synonym when their type wakes up thing.
You need to stop. The historical.
What does that mean? What does that mean? The legendary legends, article. Do they mean the legendary article from Time Magazine?
You're being too critical now.
I'm not being critical. I'm trying to understand the words that are being read.
Let me finish reading here. The historical legends that populate these urban folklores. From the ancient pyramids of Egypt to the bustling cityscapes of Greece, Japan, and Thailand, from the expansive savannas of Cape of Good Hope, Africa, is a study in contrast and a testament to the indomitable spirit of the humanity and the essence of Junkanoo. This momentous and newfound study by local Bahamians have ushered in an era in an emerging legacy of a
What?
I think this was translated from a different language.
No, AI wrote this.
This isn't reading like English.
No, here's the thing, right?
This is very weird.
Is it historical legends or is it folklores? And urban folklores, do they mean urbane or do they mean urban?
Yeah, it can be urban.
Right? I think they mean modern stories.
Yeah, this is odd. But anyway, maybe...
And then also, is it a folklore if you're talking about people who actually existed?
Right, exactly.
Because folklore implies that this is a myth to explain something. Whatever. Right click away.
Okay. So some of the Jungle people getting a little
good.
Agitated.
Good.
But hey, this is... most of this, except for a couple, is new. These aren't the same old... Uh-huh. At least for Boxing Day, same old. That's going to be cute.
Prodigal Sons.
Hmm? Oh, did I leave them off? Oh, boy.
Wow.
Where's that one? Hold
wow.
on. Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
Okay. Yes, Prodigal Sons. Whoa. Forward, upward, onward, together. Just as we said, they were new. And here we go. Oh boy. On July 10th, 1973, after 300 years of being a colony, the Bahamas made a peaceful transition to a different type of colony. No, I'm changing it. Sorry. To nationhood by becoming an independent nation. The year 2023 marks 50 years of independence. Let's celebrate forward, upward, onward, together. And then, will it be there?
Is on us. Just read what the people wrote, right?
Is on us.
Is on us. Mm-hmm. It's on us. Mm-hmm. Okay. Is on us.
Hey, man. And hey, all the information about the B groups is in there too. I don't mean to not read it, but we're running out of time.
I mean, those ones make more sense.
They probably do. It's all in the exclusive Junkanoo supplement in today's NASA Guardian, folks. You can go through it all weekend long leading up to Christmas night and the Boxing Day parade, which begins at 10 p.m. on Bay Street.
Along with us.
This is fascinating. I'd love to see what's going on in the minds of our people.
Right. We should hand this off to a therapist, definitely.
It's beautiful. And can you imagine how this will be represented on Bay Street on Monday, Tuesday?
Stream of consciousness, I think that's what they call it. Mm-hmm. It's like abstract.
Get Steven some fruitcake, please, or something. Eggnog.
That's what this looks like. That's what these words look like, a fruitcake or black cake. Just a mishmash of.
What is this black cake thing that people keep talking about? I've never heard of this.
It's from a different culture. It's not Bahamian, but it's a Christmas thing.
Is it like Jamaican fruitcake, which is like more of a pudding type thing? Is it more like that?
See, pudding just means dessert. But so you take
it's not like a cake.
It's like a fruit cake, but then you ground up everything. Mm-hmm. And so instead of it being like lumps, I think it's like it's a cake texture. Right.
What, cake or
it's a cake.
Pudding texture? So
I've never had it. It looks like a cake texture to me.
It looks like a cake, but it's not.
You know what? Why don't we?
So you've never
it?
Had Jamaican fruit cake before?
No.
Okay, we can get you some of that. You
I don't
see
like
it's
fruit
very
cake.
Different. No, but you would like. Jamaican fruit.
That's what all Jamaicans say, but
it's a totally different thing.
Okay.
And it's better.
All right.
We'll get you some. All right. Let's take a break. We're going to the news. This is Morning Blend.
The soybean patty.
Oh, dear God. Kill his mic. We'll be back. Stay with us.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Wake up, it's a new day. Wake up, it's a new day.
Oh.
Well, welcome to Morning Blend Business on this Friday, December 22nd, 2023. Welcome back to our Morning Blend listeners. It is our final show before Christmas Day, and we're very pleased to have this. We didn't have it a couple days ago, but it's here now, and this is a great Christmas gift.
I think it
just
is.
Just in time. This is a great way to do it. This happened for a reason.
The last working day for whoever is working before the holidays.
Exactly. And reminding people that this is still a good gift for
yes,
people.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Wine bottle underneath the Christmas tree.
Oh, absolutely. Sure.
You know, anything else.
So here's the thing, Kyle, right? I'll just jump right into it.
I haven't introduced everybody yet. Let me introduce everybody. Kyle Stubbs, Tori Saunders. We got Zena. Is Zena going to talk with us today? She might talk.
She is.
Okay. Yeah. We've got Chester Robards. Is here because he's always here when we do the segment.
The Guardian beverage expert.
Right. Okay. Well, I don't know about that. But he's here. Hello. You know what? Hello, Chester.
I'm just going to be
And
quiet.
Stephen Hanna is still here. Yeah, now, we brought in Chester because Stephen doesn't consume alcoholic beverages.
Okay. At this time of the year.
Or ever, apparently.
Yeah, it's like.
So, and he thinks he's superior to the rest of us.
I mean, not everybody at the table, but definitely some people.
We're all entitled to our opinion.
Right.
We're all entitled to our opinion as well. So.
Right.
It's all good.
So, anyway, sure. Kyle, I recently purchased a bottle of Amaro.
Oh, you right? did?
But
oh.
I didn't know that we had a Bohemian brand. Because had I known that, then I would have purchased this because this is such a better gift than than you know just getting a random
Amaro.
Yeah, right. So it's like this. This company is local?
Yeah, it's local. So it's a subsidiary of Bristol Wines and Spirits. And we started off as Bahamas Botanicals.
Okay.
And Zena's going to jump in a little bit to give us a little... She's been on the, you know, the getting this product to market kind of thing. But it's about local or sourcing local raw ingredients.
Mm. I see it says cascarilla on it. Yeah. And cascarilla is one of the foundational... ingredients for Campari and like right and so but I'm guessing so that whole licorice medicinal weird strong flavor that
for somebody
like,
who does not drink my friend you are spot on
because you don't have
to drink
to drink to know about it
So Kyle, we're gonna get to Amaro
especially
in a bit.
It's such a big part of the African industry. Let's talk about it, Zena.
Oh gosh! All right, we need to. Where's the sleigh? We need to tie him up with some of that rope in the corner so that we can. We need to frame the show so people know what we're talking about.
Indeed,
Kyle, what are we gonna be discussing?
Right, a new product, produced here locally, 100% local ingredients, and it's a very very nice concept. Right, it's a digestive in terms of when we look at. Liquor and liqueur categories.
Mm-hmm.
It has some medicinal elements to it. But I think we thought it would have been ideal to bring it on radio today and introduce it because we're all going to eat heavy over the next week and a half.
Right.
And this is one of those after you eat a heavy meal, it's an aperitif? Is that how you pronounce it?
The aperitif is before. Aperitif. The digestive is after.
Thank you.
So this is
a digestive.
Yes. Oh, okay. So assist with the breakdown and the ease of the food, you know, getting to where it needs to go.
The other guy sells itself as an aperitif.
Which other guys?
This
that?
Is Campari.
Yeah. Again, we're still talking about you know some of the raw ingredients in both both beverages, but it's stylistically what we do to get the end product that makes it the difference, the alcohol content as well.
Now, what I know about Amaro is that it's a very complex beverage, right? And then you don't really need to mix it with a lot to get different flavors and different combinations, right?
You sure you don't drink?
I don't drink at all. Now. What I do know though, right? What I like to do is I ask people like, what soft drinks do they drink, right? Because that helps to figure out what their preference is. So like people who like those complex flavors like root beer and stuff, they tend to lean towards
a little bit more complex,
The Amaro and stuff. Yeah. But I see you guys have some recipes here. Mm-hmm. Tell us what is the suggestion?
I feel like you're jumping the gun. We got to go back a little bit. So let's go back a little bit. Tell us about
the question I wanted to do. Go ahead.
We'll get to that. Let's go back to how Bohemian Botanical came about and all of this and what's happening and how and where people can find this product.
So if anybody knows the president of Bristol Wines and Spirits, Mr. Juan Bacardi, he is going to find a way to become a little bit more involved community-wise, how we can impact our well-being, our economy, outside of us just being the largest purveyor of premium wines and spirits. Mm-hmm. And so folks would remember, he is a family member of the Bacardi when they were here in town, mm-hmm. right? And some of the things that caused them to leave in terms of the cost of raw product, raw ingredient, and shipping to produce here and then to export, kind of had them leave the country. But being in that bloodline, you know, production of spirits is always a thing. But now it's him on his own tapping into how do I support the local market. And so through this Bahamas Botanical project, the aim is to relieve some of the farmers of not knowing where their product ends up to, not having an end destination for their product. So when we look at this Cascarilla bark, is, you know, this kind of forces us to get into the production of more Cascarilla, mm-hmm. right? And then we get into, you know, the second and third beverage that we'll bring out, we'll be back into getting Eleuthera up and running with pineapples on a larger scale again into the second or third project that we'll bring in the Bahamas Botanicals. So, and then also the health component is a focus on the minimization of sugar content inside these beverages, right? So local, health conscious, and then it fits in with our whole experience that we want to have when it comes to food and beverages.
Mm-hmm. I feel like that was the second thing Juan said when he talked about Amaro. He was like, don't have all that sugar. Yeah. And I tasted it already, and I thought to myself, you know, this is less sweet than that other guy.
Yeah.
I'll just call him the other guy. Even though you all sell it. But yeah, it really is different in terms of the taste.
Yeah, I just had it for the first time on Friday.
There you go.
So is it on sale now? Where can you find it?
So Zena? It is on sale now. You can find it in all Bristol locations. It's also available in Premier Crew, and we have select retailers where it's also going to be available. But for now, you could definitely get it at Bristol in time for the holidays.
At an introductory price.
Yes.
Okay, excellent. All right, now, Stephen, I think this is a good time to ask those questions you were getting to.
Do you guys have I see that you guys have glasses here, so I'm assuming that you were going to, see any.
So we're just going to taste it neat. Okay. And then we can taste it with a cube or two of ice. Mm. And then we can discuss some of these cocktails. But like you mentioned earlier, Stephen, you're spot on. The complexity that people enjoy on soft beverages transfer over into the alcohol stuff. So you look at some of these things, you're talking about how do we twist an old-fashioned.
Right.
Only complex palates enjoy an old-fashioned.
Right.
The sweet component, the bourbon component, the orange citrus component. But now we're talking about infusing something local into this old fashioned. So for us, our old fashioned with the
Okay, I see the play on words there.
Yeah.
I didn't pick it up when I saw this thing.
All right, so they're going to be different flavors as well, as you
mentioned. No, so this is just one flavor. So what we've had our in-house mixologist come in and taste and appreciate the profile of this. Mm-hmm. And then place it with some spirits. So you'll see there's a gin cocktail. All of the cocktails are based with the Amaro.
Okay.
And then it's accented with one or two other things. So we have an Angel's Envy inside the retro, which is a bourbon.
Right.
Right? Which is what we put inside an old fashioned. We have a cocktail that includes a little bit of Patron Silver. And then there's one here that includes a little bit of Bombay Gin. Right? But again, these cocktails are professionally curated, measurements down to the T,
right,
so that we get the full experience from this. But I am a Amaro one cube of ice, life is good.
Mm.
The distiller that's on the bottle is not the mixologist. Is it?
No.
It's not the same person.
No, right. No. Both are Bahamians.
Right. Andy Fowler on the bottle.
Yeah.
Wow.
And his signature.
Yeah.
What can you tell us about the process of making it? Do you know much about that?
Is it distilled locally?
Everything happens here locally, on top of the hill, Gladstone Road. Okay. But we talk about
right
the,
there.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we talk about the maceration first, right? Which is the seeping of an alcohol with the raw ingredient. Mm-hmm. So the cascarilla and everything sits in that. So we're, you know, picking up those flavors and everything else. And then we go into the distillation, where we focus on getting the appropriate alcohol content, mm-hmm. releasing some of the unwanted ingredients inside this product, and then we end up with this fine thing. It took a lot of testing and tasting. I think the sales team tasted it maybe 2 months ago, and then a smaller group of the sales team tasted it about a Bahamas Botanicals team just to get it to the point we're at.
Wow. And how long has it been up? This is
a week, 2 weeks? How long has it been up now? 2 weeks?
So it's been about a week now on the shelves. Mm-hmm. It was, like you said, a process. So we've now finally gotten it to something that is enjoyable for a lot of the people that sampled it. And now we have it available for sale. Yeah.
Excellent.
We'll see it showing up on some cocktail menus in short order.
It sounds like some of the first iterations.
I would imagine, imagine it would be very intense.
Yeah.
Like, so, because, I mean, Cascarilla is a very... Have you smelled Cascarilla? Yeah. Oh,
yeah. It's not very raw.
It's very pudgy.
Like, it's a very strong scent, but it's not a bad scent. It's like...
These things remind me of something called Mama Wana. I think it's out of the DR. Not Marijuana. Mama Wana is a drink, and they sell the bottle with all of the trees,
bush inside
and
herbs
I've
inside
seen it.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And it is super strong. The taste is medicinal. But, you know, and when I first tasted it, I was like, oh, Mama Wana, but this tastes good.
Yeah.
But I think, I mean, also, that it has that, I mean, well, I guess, you know what? I smell like Cascola reminds me of licorice in terms of scent. I've never tasted it, so you guys can tell me what the flavor profile is, what the notes are.
Mm-hmm. So I like that everything's local. I don't know if you could say what the process of getting Cascarilla from the southern Bahamas, I assume, is where it's coming from, and as they're trying to prepare for other places.
Absolutely. You know. So I would, and I appreciate that. That's the Guardian business coming out of New Chester. And I'm going to do a little bit more digging in, because that's going to be interesting to let the folks know, right? What are we doing? What are the relationships that we have with these producers? And how are we transporting here, and what are we doing to preserve, you know, what it is that we get? Once we get to this kind of operation, then it's about the quality. It's the same thing in wine, right? We're not just growing grapes, but how do we grow good grapes? Mm-hmm. So I'm certain, you know, that's how this product and this project is going to evolve.
Well, I guess it's a good time because the government is working with
farmers
to grow specifically
Cascarilla.
Yeah. I'm going to call it Sisal because Sisal was on my mind. Because I want to see that come back to tree.
Yeah. And I feel like Cascarilla is being grown on, they're trying to grow it on other islands as well.
Yeah.
Further, like Andros or something,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm. So what's the capacity like for how much can they put out?
Produce?
Yeah.
Well, this started off as a small project. What was the case count or bottle counts, you know?
It started as a small project, but I think we produced maybe 1,000 cases. That's a mix of all the sizes. So right now it's available in the 1 liter. We have a 375 milliliter and also a 50. So, you know, the little ones that you could just like put in people's
Christmas
stockings.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, really? I didn't see those.
Yeah.
That's
cool.
Nice,
right. Nice little.
So is there a plan to maybe export in the future, or what are we looking at here?
That's definitely in the plans. Mm-hmm. But for now, we want to keep it local so you can come and you can get it where we are. But as we grow, it's definitely going to be exported in the future.
If anybody is familiar with the job line, right, was available on the export market as well. Again, so it's just us getting this, getting the appreciation for this product, getting the understanding of it, and then for sure and tapping into whatever market it is that we need to tap into.
Okay, excellent. So I know.
I think it's great. I think it's a sink. And you don't know that about Campari because people think that it's an old man drink here,
right, and it's better.
And that's what they call it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But it is a sexy brand in Europe.
Yep. Very much so.
Yeah.
Very much so.
Yeah.
And it performs a specific function.
Yeah.
Right. It isn't like it's just a bitter drink for no reason. But for those who drink Campari, which is the aperitif, the Amaro is the digestive.
Right.
Seamless transition.
Yeah.
Excellent. Enjoy both.
All right, I know Chester's ready to.
Why would I be
to
the
sample,
ready one?
And his expert knows what do you smell?
For our listening audience, we have less than an ounce in our glass, right? So we are just tasting and sampling, and it is neat. So no ice, no water, straight out of the bottle, and we're just going to see what's for sure.
So you mentioned licorice and
citrus orange stuff.
Some orange, definitely the allspice.
Right,
The
allspice. Yeah, make me think it's very Christmassy.
Yeah, so we've been focusing on the Cascarilla, but the allspice leaf, right? The pimento seed is, I just love that tree, right?
Yeah.
We use the seed or the fruit itself inside our sauce and our stews. We use the leaf, the bay leaf and reef. I just love that tree, but it comes in, this is just a very nice aromatic blend in this glass.
Just inhaling it, like you kind of just
like
get
an old fashioned, like you mentioned earlier. Yeah. It smells like, just like that.
Yeah. This would make sense with a bourbon and an orange tuile and something else.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I think the retro, I'll probably try it because I just got a bottle yesterday.
Zena insisted that we only try it neat and maybe with a glass of ice. But we were trying to.
No, that's how I
tried. I mean, no, we were trying to do a little retro.
Oh, to do it. Okay.
We might have gotten out of hand. It is the Friday before Christmas.
All right, here we go.
What does it taste like, Dwight?
This guy. It's very nice, though. It is. Like I said, I had it last week.
There's a licorice. Yeah. There's a medicinal taste. And it opens up the whole nasal.
Very spicy. Very spicy. Kind of,
the old spice shows up. The cardamom shows up on the end.
It's smooth. It doesn't sting. It doesn't burn, you know, crazy.
Just while you still have a little bit, we'll just drop an ice cube on the top of it. Mm-hmm.
And just the right amount of sweetness there, right? It's just
So this explains that the batch is rested with neutral grain spirits for 48 hours, which means you're not turning fruit and spices into alcohol through fermentation.
No, right. No. So we're adding just a neutral spirit, right? And neutral spirits for us. Neutral spirits for us to clear alcohols.
Right.
Either between a clean vodka or a clean gin, or what we considered among neutral spirits.
But that's part of the secret recipe.
We Mr. Fowler would not.
I was going to say, what's the percentage?
For people asking, they're asking about it now. You mentioned it. Introductory price. Can you say what that is, Zena?
So the introductory price, I could pull it up, but Stephen was also asking, what's the alcohol percentage? And for this bottle, it's 31% alcohol.
Okay. All right. And while you look for the introductory price, we're going to try it with
So we're just going to do a little stir just to melt a little bit of the ice. So we're just diluting, but not really trying to change the profile of the liquor. And then...
On ice. I see why you said you would pour
it. I'm talking the mic there, sir. Okay.
So the introductory prices... For the liter bottle, it's $49.95, and that includes VAT. For the 375, which is the one we brought in studio today, that's $24.50. And then the little ones that I said you should put in people's Christmas stockings is just $5.
Mm-hmm. So introductory, that implies that after that period, this is going to go way up?
Then after that, not way up, but then after that, the focus is to make sure that we cover the expenses to get this product to market.
This is just a... get a taste.
And by the street,
see how many batches they can do.
And if you're shopping around today, you can catch a sampling at our Gladstone Road store, so you can make an informed purchase after that, as opposed to just buying one bottle because we're here on radio talking about it. You can sample it and make sure that everybody is taking care of this holiday season.
Yeah.
Question: do you? I mean, I know that you guys often come on and you have your wines, you have your various. I don't want to say highfalutin spirits, but your what's the word? High grade? Your premium. Premium, that's the word. I couldn't remember the word.
High grade is mama wanna.
Right.
Yeah, we don't know high grade spirits.
Do you guys making that transition from, like, to say, okay, let's try something different? Because you know a lot of people be like, oh, this is, I know this. And that's the only thing they ever try. They don't ever try anything different because it seems... frightening to be like, oh, well, what if I mix the wrong thing and all this sort of stuff?
So we try, and what it takes to move a consumer from a comfort zone to something, to trying something different, I think is a little bit of confidence and competence on the sales side of things. How do we have a conversation with a customer, right? Because, and then it's product knowledge. So we've done a little bit of that focus this year, and we'll do a lot more of that in the new year. Because if you like this, then I can probably suggest three other things. What we try to stay away from is, I like this, you don't have this, so
I go on to something. That tends to, sometimes for me, that feels more like a brand thing, where it's like, this is the name that I'm familiar with. So if you don't have this, then I'll just go elsewhere.
So we try to develop a relationship and create family kind of feelings amongst our customers. So you can trust whether it's a Tori or Kyle or Zeno or any of our sales reps inside the retail space. on a suggestion based on the questions that they ask. It isn't just to sell you something, but we want to ask one or two questions. Oh, that question, here's this. And then we also ask you to come back and let us know what that experience was like. If we were spot on, we'd like the pat on the back. If we weren't, then we revisit what our suggestions is. We want to be true to what it is that we're doing.
You know, that's what I appreciate about you guys. Is you could come talk to you about deeply about the things that you sell and the taste that you have, whereas some other guys, you just like...
If we don't want to take it for granted that, you know, we're trying to get you to buy 50, 60, 150, $1,500 bottles of wine, right? So we want to be true to it and start off the experience with truth. So when you open that bottle, you know, that finishes off the experience and your $1,500 spent.
Right. What else? It's also how you're drinking a 1,500 bottle of wine.
Yeah, good people, good company. Keeping it on the shelf. Right, and or in your back trunk of your car.
But then also, like, aren't you, some of these things supposed to breathe, right?
Yeah.
But like, you just chugging the vibe.
No, we don't just chug the vibe.
That's what I said. Like, if you're treating it like Frontier, a Colorado, right? If we're gonna treat it like that, I'm saying, like, there are people who will buy a gallon of that.
Yeah.
And they treat it like Kool-Aid, and that's fine.
Yeah, that's perfect.
There's a space for that. The beach picnic.
Right, and it's made to be drunk like Kool-Aid.
Right, but there's another.
Get rid of it.
But if you're gonna spend a lot of wine.
Yeah, you want
let it to the wine breathe.
Right, and let it be in the best possible condition before you consume.
And we've done a whole show on that. Yes. The right glassware to have. You got to really treat it properly.
Most definitely.
This is really interesting. The longevity here, which actually has the Amaro and Campari. So there is room for both. That's
and Bombay Sapphire.
And Bombay Sapphire, right? So it's an interesting take on a Negroni or something, I guess. Yeah, it's similar to that.
There you go.
So I'm very curious about that one. All right. And I am a Campari fan.
I'm certain we'll be doing some more samplings, and we probably will have a happy hour around Amaro in the new year with some of these cocktails being featured kind of thing.
Okay. Sounds wonderful. Yeah. Sounds wonderful.
I hope you all put a whole section just for Amaro.
If you go in the Gladstone Road store right now, I was surprised 2 days ago, and I was like, whoa, that's the whole rack, the whole shelf.
Okay.
All right, be selling Amaro this holiday.
Great. No,
but then and also
like an Amaro bar.
But people will buy it. Well, one, the fact that you guys have the Christmas stocking stuffer size ones, right? Those are cool because you can
just
buy
to try it,
You can buy but bosses should do it. Like, right? Right, but then also because it's something bohemian, people are gonna be like, I'm going to buy it because now it's special. And Ian is in a mass produced thing that coming from the other side of the world. Right, and it don't have no appeal to us locally. Yeah.
Faces and names that we know.
How many Bahamians are involved in the process?
All Bahamians.
Okay,
100% of the operation is
directly. How many people would be in the?
They want to know how many people in the distillery
working in the factory.
Directly, everything is Bahamian. We get our cascarilla locally. Mm-hmm. We get all of our other ingredients locally. Our master distiller, Andy. He is a Bahamian.
Is he doing it by himself or are there other people
with
him?
So he has
there?
Some interns working in there with him. Bahamians. They are also all Bahamian. Yeah. We have a student that went to UB and he helps Andy. It's a Bahamian.
Well, I'm asking how many numbers? Like, what's the number of people?
Very small.
It's a very small.
Oh,
it's
wow.
like a boutique distillery.
Okay.
So it's a small team, but they're all Bahamians. Even the
Excellent.
Label, we got the label designed by Lamaro Smith, who is a Bahamian
Excellent.
Graphic designer. So it's completely, we want from the start to the end product to be 100. Local and 100% Bahamian.
So what Bahamas Botanical benefits from is being a subsidiary of Bristol Group of Companies is the network, the channel, the distribution that Bristol has.
Mm-hmm.
So they're just focused on giving us good product.
No, let me ask
take it from there.
Let me ask a question then. Like, what Bahamas Botanical is not just going to be Amaro, I'm guessing.
No.
So what else? First of all, are there
First
anything
of all.
Else?
That's a technical foul.
Right, no, I'm saying are there other products?
There's stuff in the pipeline.
This is the first thing you're releasing or were there other things before this?
No, this is the first. This is the
all
first.
Right.
This is the first of it. Right.
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, closer.
Job has a line. So this is the first thing from
Bahamas Botanical.
Bahamas Botanical.
Right.
The job also has the XO, the EXO.
All right.
A vodka and everything else.
Right.
So job was what started off this whole conversation about health benefits in the beverages that we did,
mm-hmm.
right? And trying to get Bahamians to know what's in the beverages. So what makes up our herbal beverage and what does it do? The fact that the vodka from Jab is 100% potato vodka, right? The rum, right? We can make rum from molasses, from sugarcane.
Anything with starch.
But we wanted to be specific to know that this came from sugarcane and where the sugarcane come from. So that was the precursor to this, which is now 100% local, using local ingredients.
Now you have me questioning if the next thing is going to be like a vodka from cassava or something.
Who knows?
A lot of silence.
Who knows? But you asked us a good question just based on starch base being the vodka of choice and what we grow here locally, starch based.
It's not a platin. I mean,
Zena, you might have to have a conversation with Stephen.
The Jab sugarcane rum, by the way, is the best.
Oh, that's there you go. Beautiful.
The best.
Yeah.
That's one of those wonderful bottles you don't, that's one of those you hoard. You don't share
that. And it's hard to keep in stock. I honestly, I can't tell you. What I could tell you is I know that Bristol East Bay has 8 bottles on the shelf.
8?
Yeah.
Now the people who listen, who are looking for it.
Right. Well, I can't tell you if any other Bristol's has it right now in inventory or what size, but I can guarantee you if you're a Jab sugarcane rum person, there's 8 bottles in the East Bay store.
It's unbelievable. And don't mix it with anything, right?
No. That's how we did this Amaro this morning. We're very neat, a glass of ice, and you're good. Please, no Coca-Cola. Definitely no Diet Coke.
And no cranberry.
I mean, you know, some people... Wait, what?
People do it. Ah, boy. All right, let's take a break. When we come back, we've got a lot more to talk about. We're going to talk about the sales. The sale's still going on,
indeed,
right? All right. And then you've got another bottle here.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that. We're having a party in the studio, folks. This is Morning Blend Business on Guardian Radio 96.9.
Jingle bells ring, snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, rock. Jingle bells chiming, jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in the one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, rock. Jingle bell chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
Feel the rhythm of the Bahamas this holiday season with Scotiabank. Get ready to dance to the Junkanoo. Spend $20 or more with your Scotia Card MasterCard debit and you could win a ticket to the vibrant New Year's and Boxing Day Junkanoo parades. Don't miss a chance to experience a true Bahamian treasure. Where will your Scotia Card take you this holiday season? Terms and conditions apply. For more details, visit bs.scotiabank.com.
Earning zero interest on your savings at the bank? With as little as $100, you can start earning interest on your money while you're sleeping, eating, or standing in line at the bank with the CFAL Savings Express Plan. Ready to invest? Start by putting $1,000 into our mutual funds and earn interest there too. Because at CFAL, your interest is our interest. Visit CFAL.com to start now. CFAL. Growing wealth for future generations of Bahamians.
Cashmas is here at Percy's Island Game. 78 winners, $250,000 in cash and prizes, and a grand prize of $50,000 in cash. And there's more! 7-day Caribbean and Alaska cruises, 7-day trips to New York, Las Vegas, and London, TVs, iPads, cell phones, and 3 brand new 2023 Toyotas. Enter to win each time you deposit $20 on your verified account at the only place with the cash, the cruises, the toys, the trips, and the cars this Cashmas, and that's Percy's Island Game.
It's a million-dollar Christmas, and Everybody Wins is hooking you up. From December 1st to December 29th, you can win cash giveaways. Get into the cash vault, spin and win, and take advantage of other random raffle drawers. Prizes like more payments, utility bills cleared, cold cash, and more. To enter, you must sign up and get a verified account, and simply spend $20 or more, and you're in. To be eligible, you must be 18 and over. It's a million-dollar Christmas with Everybody Wins. Terms and conditions apply.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment terms that suits your financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell time and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Go gliding in the one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle, that's the jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
What a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in the
getting
one
into the music there. All right, welcome back to More Than Business on Guardian Radio 96.9. Dwight Strong, along with Chester Robards and Stephen Hatter. We got them both in studio with us this morning. And we've got our friends from
people
Bristol. Oh boy, they're like, why is Stephen talking so much this morning? Like, right. we've got our friends from Bristol Wines and Spirits with us. We've got Kyle and Tori and Zena with us. We're having a great time. All right, so you got a big sale going on. It's still going on, right?
Mm-hmm. So two things. You got two sales.
Mm.
Unfortunately, or fortunately, one ends today.
Wow.
Tomorrow, sorry, Saturday. Okay. So you got 2 days, the Pop Wines and Spirit location.
Mm-hmm.
That's Blake Road. Our main wine focus store. That's Premier Crew on the top of the hill. That's Gladstone Road on the top of the hill. Mm-hmm. And that's East Bay at the foot of the bridge on the backside of where the old Outback Steakhouse used to be. Things up to 45% off.
Wow.
This is that one time of the year where you can get things that you won't get any. We might have a spring sale or summer sale, and it'll be 25% off or 30%, but it won't go as high as we're offering now. And that ends tomorrow. A couple of things are on buy to get one free. So get all your Christmas gifts, all your stocking fillers and everything else. And when that ends on Saturday, then we start next week with the champagne sale.
Oh, just in time for New Year.
Just in time for New Year's. And so we have some sparkling wines and some champagne on sale as a part of our retail sale that ends tomorrow. But then the sale next week is focused 100% on sparkling wines and champagne. So
and how big a sale is that one?
That goes up to the same thing, about 35 to 40% off.
Okay.
And those things start off from your $5 to $10 sparkling wines straight up to some very new champagnes that we just bought and some vintage Blanc de Blancs from some very well-known houses kind of thing. So, it you know, we want you to be very price conscious around the Christmas dinner selection and make sure it's more about having something on the table that can fit all of the palates that you're inviting. But then we are also encouraging you to kick it up or not and celebrate turning 23 into 24 in style with a good champagne.
Yeah,
well, for the Dao lovers who...
indeed, Dao is on sale, my friend.
Yes, you can get a nice I copped a bottle of Bodyguard.
Listen, the Bodyguard in the cab. The cab is at $30.
Yeah.
You can't beat that in the Bodyguard, I think, dropped down to...
Excellent stuff.
All right. It's going to be expensive.
All right.
That's my top shelf right there.
Yeah.
All right, don't judge me.
What do we have? What is this?
So
it smells amazing.
I'm going to double check to see if it's on the sale. Yeah, I think it is. But we brought out something that represents what I think our palate enjoys, but where the wine world is moving. So everybody's been drinking Napa, right, for a very long time and thinking it's the best of the best of what California has to offer. And for a long time, that's what it was. But everything now coming out of Paso Robles is what people are enjoying. So Chester just mentioned about Dow, and every time I see him, it's about Dow. So Dow and Paso Robles sticks in Chester's mind. So
there's no doubt.
There's a place and there's a profile, right? And so with Iron and Sand, we had Iron and Sand before we brought in Dow to represent us understanding the changes that's happening inside the wine market. So we're getting a little bit of an apple or full bold expression at less than half of the price that we would get for the same wine from Napa Valley, just, you know, 200, 300 miles up kind of thing. And so, you know, I just thought it would be nice to bring a brand that Tori represents because he's been good enough to come and join us this morning on a vacation day. And this belongs...
Dedication.
This belongs to the Trinchero family who owns Sutter Home, right?
Oh, okay.
The largest producer of White Zinfandel. Produce 25 million cases of wine on a yearly basis.
Wow.
18 of those million cases are White Zinfandel. A quite large amount of those cases end up in our market, kind of thing. But this is their serious approach to wine, understanding place, soil, terroir, grape variety, and here we end up with a fantastic bottle.
All right. So, Tori,
go ahead.
Tell us about it. Is it cab? Cabernet Sauvignon.
What is a cab?
Let's get that.
What's a cab?
Oh, sorry.
You don't drink at all?
Let's get right into that mic, Tori.
But but when you were pouring it, it's like it was weird. From a distance, it smelled like Ribena. Right? And it seems like
you want us to kill his mic?
No. I'm sorry, and I didn't mean to stop you because people laugh at me when I say this in training sessions, right? When I was away in schools training on wine, they forced me to understand what this cassis aroma was, or blackcurrant, things that are not quite familiar to us, right? But I drank a whole lot of Ribena. And so when I'm tasting and smelling red wines blindly, and I can identify sea grapes or Ribena, it's a cab or a cab blend.
Okay.
So I just grabbed the mic when Steven said that. Said, listen, somebody who doesn't drink, said on radio, when Tori opened that bottle, he smelled Ribena. That's a cab.
Well, look at that.
Because once again, you don't have to you know, to drink it to appreciate it.
There's
a get it.
It's like, you go around, you sniff. You sniff a lot.
I mean, no. Like yeah, I'm surrounded. Right. I'm surrounded by people who drink on their job. So
or drink for a job.
Right.
Well,
Tori.
They're journalists,
exactly.
So they claim that they're drinking for their job.
Exactly.
So.
You know, when I may speak in.
Yes,
class,
but yes. Right.
Yeah.
Who is this guy?
Oh, my. We'd be afraid if Steven were to drink, actually. So it's probably for the best.
Probably for the best.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's right. But okay, so what can you tell us about this? So this smells expensive. It looks expensive. Is that what this is?
Expensive.
No. Zena's saying no.
It is on the sale list, so it's usually about $37, $38. And right now, until Saturday, you can get it for $25.
Mm, okay. Wow, that's pretty decent.
Behemoth's Love, 14.1% alcohol. Mm-hmm. So it's up there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's up there in alcohol.
All right. Chester, your expert nose.
Me? Nose?
Mm-hmm. Other than Ribena, what do you smell?
No, not sea grapes, though.
It's a good nose.
Mm-hmm.
It is a good nose. I don't want to say it reminds me of like a communion. The look. I'm looking at it.
Oh, you mean the
color? I'm not tasting it.
Like,
yeah. Like,
okay.
Like,
I think I would let it breathe.
What's the vintage on?
It's 2019.
Oh. We have a little bit, 3-4 years on it. But it is, again, a big wine.
Mm-hmm.
So by letting it breathe, we can, you know, the aroma. We like to say it's boozy when you can smell the alcohol on it, right? We want to get some of that unwanted components or elements to release itself, right? And so we want the wine to soften up a little bit and so we can get a little bit more of the fruit character. But it is a big wine. So, and when we talk about letting it breathe, this would be one of those things, not where you open the bottle and let it sit, filling a decanter and quickly pouring it in the decanter, letting the decanter be the vessel that the wine's sitting and that you pour. So you're inviting a little bit more oxygen into it. So it's changing the consistency of the molecules in the wine.
I also wonder right now if Amaro is chilling on my tongue.
Exactly. I'm thinking the
same
thing.
Like when you brush your teeth and then dry drink something.
I'm feeling that as well. I think if we had done the reverse order, it might have been a little more enjoyable.
This is just a big wine. Mm. This is a big, heavy wine.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you get that. Yeah.
Mm. And some people, this is them, like 14.1%. And some people is, give me my cab.
Is 14 a, more. A lot for a wine?
Yeah, we top out at 15%.
Okay. What would you pair this with in terms of food?
Oh, big steaks.
Yeah.
Big steaks. Like, and people say I'm bougie, but you know, like a tomahawk coming off the grill. Mm. Nice bone.
I would have said that too.
A bone in ribeye, New York. These will all be perfect with that. Some lamb chops would be perfect on the side of this as well. But this is a big wine. So this is something heavy to be.
Iron and Sand is not this actual name of this. Yeah. That's the name of the company.
That's the name of the winery. That's the brand.
The winery, okay.
Right. So the company is Trinchero, right, which include things like Ménage à Trois, Sutter Home.
Right.
And Iron and Sand.
Ménage à Trois too.
Yeah.
Would you pair this with your typical Christmas dinner?
What I would do is I would pull this out after dinner, and the guys are sitting in the front room watching the basketball game.
It is a sipping type one. Yeah.
And talking some nonsense or whatever the case may be. This will be when I pull it out. Because again, this will only speak to a certain set of palates.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Those who want an alcohol punch, a big heavy wine, they don't care if it's only seafood on the table, they want this type of wine. But outside of that, you know, the small conversations that'll be in the back patios and TV rooms.
Yeah.
They pull out a bottle of Iron Sand. Yeah. I think it'll be a good end to Christmas.
Would you recommend?
You're talking about a couple of minutes, 10, 15, 20 minutes kind of thing.
Okay.
It's just creating a larger space so all of those unwanted aromas and stuff can escape, and then you're serving the beverage in its best possible form.
Yeah.
Would you cool this at all?
I was going to say this is something that I would probably put in the fridge for 5 to 7 minutes and then pull it back out. Yeah. Even though we only usually typically do that with Pinot Noir, this is a big wine. And if you were thinking about, you know, we've had all year the conversation about room temperature and storing our, this right here is our window of leaving the wine on the counter.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The third week of January is when we need to be looking at the wine fridge like Dwight has to make sure we're storing the wine properly. But for the next 2 to 3 week window, you know, it's okay to leave the wine on the counter,
right,
you know, in the cupboard while we're experiencing these low 60s kind of thing.
You'd need, no, because then, okay, because I know that the reason why, I know sunlight brings, it makes alcohol go bad, right? And that's why wine is usually inside, like, darker bottles. But you're saying that keeping it dark and cool is not enough. You need to have, like, cool, not room temperature cool.
Right, no, what I'm saying is our room temperature isn't dark and cool enough for wine storage. Right. But this type of temperature that we've been experiencing over the last 7 days.
But it's cold now.
Yeah. But this is what they consider room temperature in wine-producing countries.
Okay.
Like France and Germany and Italy kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So that's why I'm saying right now is the only time you can be a little careless and leave it on the counter.
Usually behemoth rooms are like saunas.
Right.
Yeah.
So as soon as we, you know, one switch of the wind in January and we have a 92-degree day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Then it's time to say no. The wine
might
needs
even
to
be next week.
Yeah, we need to start at Bristol or purchase a wine fridge kind of thing.
And what if the person just kept it inside their fridge all the time, like a regular fridge?
Especially if you put the red in, then you're gonna change the profile of the wine.
Mm.
And what we want to do, just as you spoke about sun exposure,
right,
is the actual heat. The molecules start to misbehave. They will misbehave as well when we start to say, hey, cool down, warm up, cool down, warm up. It's the same thing with food, not keeping it in the proper temperature zone for certain time. It goes back and it's the exact same thing.
I love how we always get a chemistry lesson. Well,
this is very important stuff.
The last question, I promise.
Really
right?
Quickly, running out of time.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what is the point of legs? Like, what are we looking for when we look for legs?
So, and I appreciate that question, Stephen. So folks like to use the reference of legs in a wine glass in terms of the quality of the wine, but that's I can't be no further from the truth.
It's a myth. Is it just a texture thing or?
100%. And the textually is just to understand what the body of that wine would be. Just like we would say if we were to pour skim milk in a glass versus whole milk in a glass,
right,
we're going to get two different
flows.
It's the same thing. If you have a Pinot Noir in a glass and a Cabernet in a glass. Right. Pinot Noir is much more lighter, so it's just going to run down the glass. The Cabernet, as we're enjoying, is much more heavy. It's going to stay. So it's going to give us an indication of the texture of the wine.
And what you're looking for.
Right, and that kind of leads us into where we would be with an alcohol content.
Mm. Okay.
Right?
So the higher the alcohol content, the longer the legs? Or?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So just as we're talking here about Paso Robles, 14.1% alcohol, if we were to bring a French Pinot Noir here at 13.5, it'll be more of a water consistency than this heavy thing. But it does not speak to the quality of a wine, because we can have a light Pinot Noir at $1,500 that pours like water and a $20 cab. And because it sticks on the glass.
And it tick.
Yeah.
And she tick. I understand.
This is why. Right.
We are out of time, but really quickly, final words to folks who are pulling out their hair because they don't know what to bring to the Christmas party, to the Christmas dinner. What to do?
Two things. Don't pull out your hair. Mm-hmm. Stop in the Bristol Wines and Spirits store. Today, Gladstone will be the preferred choice. You get a full team lending you some assistance. But we also want to thank the listening public who've been dialed in with us for the entire year. I think Tori and I, and Zeno, over the last couple of months have had the conversations about, you know, the call-ins and the text messages have been increasing. And so, you know, we're seeing and feeling and packing up. You know, this year has been a pleasure, and we look forward to what exciting things we can do in the new year. But most importantly, to all of our customers, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a happy and prosperous new year.
Thank you. It has been a pleasure. We hope we can continue this for many years to come. Thank you so much to all of you every month. We need to try to do this more than once a month.
Yeah, we got to knock on some doors.
We'll talk. Kyle Stubbs, thank you so much. Tori Saunders. Zena, remind me of your last name, Zena.
Williams,
thank you so much. We're going to see a lot more of you and hear a lot more from you in the new year as well, right?
She has no choice in it.
Okay. Well, Steve and Hannah, thank you so much. Merry Christmas. We hope this conversation has brightened your mood and made you less grinch-like.
I'm saving all of my condemnations for next week, right before the new year.
Wow, you're going to end the year on a sour note. Eh?
No, not on a sour note. I'll bring all my scriptures and stuff.
Okay, all right.
I need to talk about the temples of Satan.
Oh, dear. All right. Chester Robards, I'm going to leave that with you for next week.
I have a few days off again.
I'll be back in 2024.
Let me some vacation days.
Well, okay. Everybody be safe. And we will talk again next year, but we will be back on Wednesday. Guardian Radio will return. Everybody have a safe, wonderful, Merry Christmas. And stay tuned for On the Clock with Aaron Green. I almost said Merry Christmas. On the Clock with Aaron Green, coming up next.
Scotia is turning your wishes into wins this holiday season. Spend $120 or more on your Scotia credit card between October 25th and January 10th, 2024 for a chance to win an amazing prize valued at $15,000 plus two consolation prizes of $5,000 each. Don't have a Scotia credit card yet? Apply today for a Scotiabank credit card online at bs.scotiabank.com or visit any Scotiabank branch. Conditions apply.
Ready to save? You can put $100 into the CFAS plan and make sure your money keeps growing. Earn interest on your savings while you're sleeping, eating, or standing in line at the bank. Ready to invest? Start by putting $1,000 into our mutual funds and earn interest there.